front door. I think good. Yeah, you good.
Good?
Yeah.
Call law. Yahweh Bashim Yahushai. Shalom to the house of David. 144,000 by Yahweh Tavodah. Double answer to the men. They gave life for this truth. Then Yahweh Shai shall rise first. The double answer to the elders, the great millstone, tells the truth. And to the Israelite brothers and sisters out there, who are you Negroes, Latino Native Americans, you are the true Hebrew Israelites. And we're living in the last days. And the King of Kings, Yahweh Shai, the man you ignorantly call Jesus Christ, is coming back. A black man from the tribe of Judah to come and bring the kingdom to the nation of Israel. Now, we're basically, before the kingdom comes, right now, we're in the process of pushing out this word. We're on a mission to push his word until Yahweh Shai says to stop. You know what I mean? Because the time's going to come in Amos 8 chapter. Give me that Joel 2nd chapter 2. Because this devil's kidnapping our children. And that's in the air right now, man. Here it is. Esau kidnapped us from the west coast of Africa. Yeah. Right? He kidnapped the kingdom of Judah, Benjamin, Levi, you so-called Negroes, Latino Native Americans, and he slaughtered you Native Americans over here. He captured all you Tuol tribes, you Inca Indians, you Mayan Indians, you Aztec Indians, you Seminole Indians, Native American, Taino Indians, all right? You Central American Indians, you Dominicans, you Puerto Ricans, you so-called Negroes, West Indians, and Haitians. He kidnapped you from the west coast of Africa and brought you over here. Now here it is, this devil showing his horns. You have the two school districts over here. In a matter of what, like 3 days apart, one Edomite teacher, he told the students to draw pictures of slavery, to draw posters of slavery. And then a couple of days after that, you had another Edomite teacher, because it was a substitute, because the regular teacher took off. The substitute teacher was talking about, was reenacting slavery. Actually, he sold on slavery auctioning blocks, right? And that's the Most High doing that, man. And the little Jake was being sold to an Edomite slave master. But the Most High is doing that to wake your asses up. Then you have the 14 Israelite girls missing up in D.C., which is more than that. They're saying there's 60,000 Israelite women missing throughout the United States, man. And you know what? And they said, even though it's being oppressed, the news, over there in Savannah, Georgia, which that was a big port too, Virginia and Georgia was a big port for the kingdom of Judah, of slaves. Over there, they found a bunch of girls being sex trafficking, man. And you can't really find a lot of information on it. Esau's been doing this, but through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, the evil that this devil does behind closed doors is being found out. And this devil's fucking scared. Go ahead. You got this for me?
Joel chapter 2, verse 1.
Okay.
Blow ye the trumpet in Zion, and sound an alarm in my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord cometh.
What's that right there, brother?
That's just that pop up.
Yeah. Keep going.
For it is nigh at hand, a day of darkness and gloominess, a day of clouds and of thick darkness.
Hey, Carrie Hilson, she dreamed about that, man. She had a dream that the UFOs came and it was going to war. It was an intergalactic war. And that's going to happen. The UFOs, the chariots are going to come. And it's heavy because last night, we were trying to upload the video, but they couldn't upload. Spirit Demon Satan was doing this thing, being annoying, being a little annoying little kid. And we couldn't upload the video. But in the video, she said that she had a dream of the UFOs coming and the chariots was getting busy. And it was really dark, she said. And it was the end of the world. So it was the end of Esau's world, man. Go ahead.
As the morning spread upon the mountain, a great people and a strong, there hath not been ever.
Get the scripture. Ever you got. Delight. You got a scripture?
It's rocking out.
Yeah.
You want to Joel 3?
Yeah, hold on. Read the scripture for me. Hold on.
So Joel chapter 3, verse 1 says, for behold, in those days and in that time shall I bring again the captivity of Judah and Jerusalem, and I will gather all nations, and will bring them down into the valley of Jehoshaphat, and will plead with them there for my people and for my heritage Israel, whom they have scattered among the nations and parted my land.
And that's Jehoshaphat, man, the Most High judgment. So the Most High is mustering this third world war, man. And this third world war is going to be deep, man. This war that you see with Russia coming against the United States, China talking shit, North Korea popping off, South Korea popping off, Pakistan and India talking about they're going to shoot missiles on each other, United States and Russia going back and forth. And Russia, I believe yesterday, said that you keep fucking around, this is going to start a war. They've been talking that talk. And they keep building up missiles. They have something called the SS-18 missile, which they saying that's like even worse. That they basically call that saying that's that missile Satan, man. 10,000 times stronger than atomic bomb. You have one missile that can destroy a whole fucking five states. Just one missile, nuclear missile, man. So you think those missiles was built for nothing? No, those missiles was built for the Most High's judgment, man. That's the times that we're living in. Go ahead.
Con, verse 3. And they have cast lots for my people and have given a boy for an harlot and sold a girl for wine that they may drink.
And they're doing that now. Musket, guns, and wine? That's what the transatlantic slave trade was all about. So what's the big deal? Why? I mean, what's the big deal? What's a big deal to you tribes out there when you get surprised? Why are you getting surprised? Esau kidnapped your ass from the west coast of Africa. Esau kidnapped the children. Esau fed your children to the crocodiles. Killed your babies, man. Stomped your babies' heads out. So why are you surprised when they find out this is happening? And mind you, it's not the media that's showing this. It's the social media. And how did this truth came out? How did I wake up to the truth? To the social media, man. By way of Yahweh Shem Yahushai, by way of the Great Millstone. That's how I learned, by way of the internet. So you even got these other truthers, Dabu 7 and all these other truthers. They're coming out and exposing you, elite Edomite, Rothschilds, man. Go ahead.
God, that's why, one of the Rockefellers, I believe, said that the worst thing was to build it, to create the internet. Yeah. Man. You know, the internet is the main avenue that the Lord has used to not only bring out this truth, okay, of the scriptures, but also to show the wickedness of Esau too. You know, Esau can't hide anymore from the wickedness that he's doing. Yeah. That's why you're having so many different videos of you know, all throughout the four corners of the earth, but all throughout the four corners of America, showing, you know, the disdain that Esau has for Jake, you know? So much so that, you know, cops, you know, they're trying to make a law now that you can't even record them, because now they're showing, now it's being publicized how, you know, prejudiced and how racist cops are towards Israel. You know, so they're ultimately, like our brother said before, ultimately gonna have to shut down the internet, man, because it's not just the media, it's mainly the social media that is bringing forth the wickedness, the evilness, you know, the sorcery, the witchcraft that Esau is doing, man. And it's and also at the same time, it's waking up Israel to who they really are, you know. So keep
matter
going.
Of fact, they were seeing that in a community meeting against the police. They was talking about that in D.C. and they was bringing out charges of cops over there in D.C. raping Israelite women, kidnapping Israelite women. And the proud ass Edomite chief was like, y'all ain't gonna scare me out of here. I'm still gonna stand here. And everybody, yo, Jake's getting tired of shit. And all the other heathens, they're getting their hands on new tribes too. Yeah, the Korean over there in North Carolina that choked out that Israelite sister, that choked her, which was choking out. You can see he had that hatred. He already had it on the floor in the chokehold, and then his wife was holding her hand, and he just had that hatred in him. He just choked the shit out of her. Because all these heathens had their way on you tribes, man. And the Lord is breaking through the, yo, thank, the Wadi HaBashim Yahushai now is in your face now. And you had the NAACP, you had the NOI, you had the Black Panther Party, and it was raising hell in Chicago. There was like a mini race war in Chicago. It was growing up in this beauty salon and shit. So all this tension is going to build up. Now you're kidnapping Israelite children and not reporting in the media, not even an Amber Alert. God. And the woman that's the leader of that Amber Alert, she got caught. Was it Laura Switzer? Or Lori Switzer? You look her up. I forgot her name. The Edomite. She got caught kidnapping Levi children, man, up in there in Haiti. She got caught. And now she's the leader of the Amber Alert. And they don't even have an Amber Alert for the Israelite children that are missing. And you're going to tell me. And the movie Get Out shows you that. The movie that just came out. They showing you what they're going to do before they do it. They're kidnapping your asses, man. Jesus telling you in your face. Go ahead.
Verse 4. Yeah, and what have ye to do with me, O Tyre and Zidon, and all the coast of Palestine? Will ye render a recompense? And if ye recompense me swiftly and speedily, will I return your recompense upon your own head?
Yeah, you're going to be sold in stock, auction, and blocks, man. I know it might sound hard to believe that. Even our people, they can't see that. But hardcore slavery, the transatlantic slave trade, that's coming back. We're going to take you devils, and you have the War of the Planet of the Apes coming out in the summer. We're going to take you devils, and we're going to wash you, and we're going to sell you, man. We're going to sell you. We're going to sell you fucking devils, man. Just like you sold us, we're going to sell you on auction and blocks, man. You're going to be the commodity, man. You're going to be the exchange. You're red asses, good?
Verse 5. Because ye have taken my silver and my gold and carried into your temples my goodly pleasant things. The children also of Judah and the children of Jerusalem have ye sold unto the Grecians, that ye may remove them far from their border.
Yeah, we were sold unto you. That's facts. Here it is, you got your crackers talking shit. That's how America was built. And all these corporations got rich off the back of our ancestors, man. That's facts, man. Here it is, all these other nations come over here and they build businesses. But we built this fucking country, man, with blood, sweat, and tears. And you're going to build our society, our kingdom, with blood, sweat, and tears. Double in our kingdom. Yes, the black man's going to get raised up. The black, Latino, Native American, the Israelite man is going to get raised up. It's going to get revenge and recompense on you. Thus say you how about Shimei Abishai. Go ahead.
God, I just want to add on. In verse 5, it says, because you have taken my silver and my gold. You know, that's talking literally, you know, actual silver and gold. But also the Lord calls us his jewels, man. You know, and you Edomites, okay, along with the Hamites and along with the Arabs, all right, the Ishmaelites, y'all took the Lord's jewels, mm-hmm. all right? You took their jewels and you carried them away into your land. Mm-hmm. Okay, and even what's his name? Adolf Hitler, man. He said what? That the Americans have basically stolen the jewels, the jewelry of the Lord, man, talking about the so-called Negroes, and not just the so-called Negroes, but the so-called Latinos and Native Americans also. Mm-hmm. So the Lord is gonna recompense you for that, man. You don't just think he's gonna get away with, you know, all that wickedness that you've been doing. All that wickedness that you did in your past, all right, the Lord said what? That he requires things of the past, okay? And now you're still doing it more and more and more. You was able to hide it for a moment, okay? You was able to, you know, hide your wickedness in the secret parts, but now the Lord is uplifting that skirt and actually, like we said before, through the social media, through the internet, is actually showing, you know, Esau how much of a devil he is, and to the point where you even got the prophecy of the Lord saying that Satan's house is divided against Satan. You got actual other Edomites that are exposing these elites for their wickedness, man. So that's how you know we at the end. You know, not only is the truth doing it, but you got so-called, like brother said, so-called truthers that are also exposing you Edomites, man.
Oh, same. They beat it by against Seattle King's game stand.
Con, you're over there in the White House, man. You got the Republican Party and the Democratic Party. They can't agree on not one legislative law. You know, this whole place is all out of whack, man. And the point is that you Israelites, man, you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans need to realize what time it is, man. You need to realize what time it is according to the scriptures, because this devil's only going to get worse and worse, man. He's only going to start doing more and more wickedness as he realizes that his kingdom is crumbling. He's not going to turn over a new leaf and just say, you know what, we messed up. He's going to try to oppress you even more and more and more. Because he knows that after his end, it's going to be the rise of Jake. All right? It's going to be the rise of the planet of the Jakes, man. So, of course, he's going to try to of course, he's going to try to destroy you as much as possible. That's why you got all this wickedness going out, man.
Yeah, the devil wants to cut the services. But guess what? You're going to get cut.
I got it.
Click on the screen.
Yeah.
That's the devil. Yeah, that's the spirit. Say, hey, you can't stop this connection, man. You devils, you Rothschilds, elites, doing all your wickedness. You're going down, man. The omen of David Rockefeller dying, Chuck Berry, the king of rock and roll. Because you're going to get rocked and rolled into slavery, literally. We're going to take scepters. When Yahweh Shai comes back, he's going to hand 144,000 scepters. And we're going to bash your fucking brains in. We're going to completely fuck you up. We're going to put you in nets. We're going to drag you in slavery. We're going to put chains around you. We're going to beat the shit out of you. We're going to fuck you up. All right? We're going to smash rocks on your head. We're going to fucking take your face and smash. We're going to turn you into a fucking jello. And you're going to go to work. And we're going to whip the fucking back out of you, man. We're going to whip you so hard, ain't going to be nothing else to whip. You're just going to be Kool-Aid, man. You're going to be a gallon of fucking Kool-Aid after we're done whipping your fucking back. All right? Just go to your leech, your Rothschild's leech. All this wickedness. And the Most High every day is getting close to that time where he's going to give us that spiritual powers, man. He's going to give us that power from heaven. Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, he's going to bestow that power upon his prophets, and we're going to come for you devils, man. This friend probably heard about Shem Yahusha. We're going to hunt you down with fucking down and your martial law troops, your army tanks, your H-1s, your B-12 bombers, your super soldiers. We're going to run through that shit to the spirit probably how about Shem Yahusha, man. You're going to know what power is about real soon. All right, you fucking assholes. That's why you had that movie, Power Rangers, and that movie showed you everything. Morphin Power Rangers, they showed you, man. These devils know. And the director of the movie, his name is Dean Israelite. Dean Israelite. And they said the crystal was a zeal, Z-E-O, but a zeal, meaning zeal. Having that mark, having that zeal, having that fire, having that passion for the Lord. He's going to morph us, man, give us that power, and we're literally going to get morphed. We get beamed up into the UFOs, the chariots that are coming. You had that rainbow fire over there in Peru. You had the UFO shut down in Peru, and over there in Peru too. South America, they stayed seeing UFOs. Last week in the airport over there in Peru, they shut the shit down. 12 UFOs is flying around. These airports, man, they be shutting shit down, and they don't say nothing, man. It's a hush-hush. They see the UFO. They see the angels, man. That white cracker Edomite, he saw the angels come out the ships, and he said they were very dark, dark skin, about 7 feet tall, I would say. And that's an understatement. You wait till when, real soon, Yahushua gonna come back. The King of Kings, he gonna come back in glory and in power, man. And the whole world gonna respect the black man. Because right now, they don't respect the black man. Starting with the tribe of Judah, man. That's the head tribe. They don't respect the black man. But the black man will get his fucking respect, okay? Yahushua, when he comes back, he gonna get respect for him, for his father, himself, and his nation, man. Because all this fucking media, through this media too, the Esau, for this Rothschild, with his wickedness, his witchcraft, the whole world don't respect Israel right now. But he's going to raise up the house of Judah, and we're going to bash your fucking brains in, man. The house of David, he's going to bash your fucking brains in, man. All the 12 tribes. Go ahead.
God, I got something. So Micah chapter 2, verse 1.
Yeah.
Woe to them that devise iniquity and work evil upon their beds.
Hey, that's what you do. You devils, you Rothschilds, here it is. You have the Georgia Guidestones 322, which was the anniversary of the Illuminati, anniversary of the Georgia Guidestones. You had the Illuminati birthday coming out, May Day, Illuminati birthday. You had the spring equinox, which that goes back to the goddess of dawn, all right? Ishtar, the morning star to the east, worshiping the women, the fertility goddess, right? But then what happened? David Rockefeller, a Rothschild, 101, he got put to death. Chuck Berry got put to death. The 14 kidnappings. All that shit that they're doing in the back, all these rituals, satanic evil blood rituals, sex trafficking, it's coming out.
God.
The brother Mark is out through the spirit. Weeks ago, he was doing videos on organ harvesting, and they do that. You ain't gonna see those Israelite children again, man. Mm-hmm. And they're gonna kidnap you more, right? And they'll be kidnapping you men too. Because guess what? Esau gonna do a whole, he's gonna take all you tribes and kidnap your ass and throw you in camps. He gonna throw you in them concentration camps because it's time to re-educate. The Willie Lynch, that time is expiring, so it needs the re-education process. And that's where the camps come in. That's where the FEMA camps come in. Hey, yo, yesterday they just had ATM. Was it the Wells Fargo's banks? Carless ATM, man, machines. You think that's a coincidence? Go ahead.
Quick pizza.
You're just so sick and tired of you fucking devils, man. You know what I'm saying? We just tired of your shit already. We fuck you devils. All your bullshit. You got these camps selling out. What's fucking wickedness going on? You fucking devils, man. Fuck you, okay? The main mission is to come at you. We don't give a fuck who's this and all this gossip and faggot shit. We're concentrating on the mission, which is you fucking pieces of shit. You're the cause of all this shit, man. All these camps you got selling out. We ain't fucking selling out, man.
Right.
All
right?
The men of Valor are not fucking selling out, okay? The spirit party, how about Shem Yahusha? We're gonna have our valor even if it takes unto death, like our big brother, man. His valor runs through us, man. All right? His spirit runs through us, you motherfucker. Go ahead.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 32. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people, and thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long.
Isn't that happening now? The children are missing. Isn't that happening now? People are mourning now. The parents are mourning. The parents are sighing and crying, man. Well, you tribes still don't want to wake up. You think America loves you? Esau loves you? Esau hates you. He hates your fucking guts. He don't even put out an Amber Alert for your children missing. He don't even put out in the media. Can't you fucking see it, man? Go ahead.
It says, and there shall be no might in thine hand.
No might, no power. Powerless, man. Hey, guess what? They're realizing that too. those parents of the Israelite children that went missing, they're realizing that they're trying to go to the cops. Well, the cops are private officers, security guards for the Rothschilds. Mm-hmm. How the fuck are you going to go to Esau when Esau's kidnapping your children? Mm-hmm. And it might not even be Esau. It might be Moab. It might be Ishmael. Because all these other nations are in your society. They're mm-hmm. in your neighborhoods. So not only Esau's having fun, having his way with you, these other heathens are. You know, the Koreans choking out the black woman. Mm-hmm. Straight up cursing out, choking out the black woman. He's not even going to put to death. These other nations don't give a fuck about you tribes, man. Go ahead.
I mean, build on that too, man. And, you know, starting with slavery, man. You know, the scriptures say what? It says, "And thy eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all day long, and there shall be no might in thy hand." It started with slavery, man, when he's splitting up the household, and you had no might in your hand, man. And how much more, like, when you're talking about the girls that were missing in D.C., those women, they got families, man. And what do you think their families are doing, man? You know what I'm saying? Understand they have no might. The same people, you know, all you so-called Negroes, you call out talking about Black Lives Matter, and then you talk about, you know, there's no justice, and, you know, talk about police brutality and stuff, but then when your people go missing, well, you can go to the same cops? You can go to the same cops that you talking shit about, man? You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, that's why our people got to be more sober and more vigilant, man, and understand that these curses are upon our people, man. You know what I'm saying? When they talking about when you see our children, Israelite men getting gunned down in the streets, man, and then the people, that's what it's talking about, man. And there should be no might in thy hand. Your family can't save. Jake can't save one another, man. Your father can't save. The fathers can't save the son from getting gunned down in the street, and the mothers can't save the women from their daughters from getting raped and getting taken from off the streets, man. And then getting their organs taken. You know what I'm saying? Through the spirit, we pushed camp today, Wednesday, and what happened at the end of the camp, man? The woman was eating at the pizzeria owned by Moab, and the police, the human services, came with social workers and took her children, man. She had two children, and they took her children, right, man? And that's exactly what she was doing. It says, "And thy eyes shall look and fail with longing for all the day long, and there shall be no might in thy hand." Only thing she could do was cry and scream and wail. And say the same thing over and over again. They took the kids. They took the children. They took, and it's, yeah. And Moab don't give a fuck about, these other nations don't give a fuck about you, man. She went right in the goddamn pizza store where she was at, crying still. And Moab came outside and waved the police down and said, "Yo, you gotta get this woman out of my store, man." And what did Esau do?
What was the mercy then?
Right in the middle of the street, did a quick U-E, got her ass out of the store, and threw her right in the back seat, man. So, yeah, the children were in captivity, and then the mother went in captivity. I have a quick precept. I'm going to go down to verse 41. Yeah. It says, "Thou shalt beg its sons and daughters, but thou shalt..." Huh? Select. Thou shalt beget sons and daughters, but thou shalt not enjoy them, for they shall go into captivity. And that's what happened, man. Starting with slavery first, because we was disobedient to the Lord's, man. Our forefathers sinned against the Heavenly Father, Yahweh. And then what? Even now, man, these curses didn't just, because we're in 2017, the curse is not on us no more. It's on us more now than ever, man. That's why our people don't even know. Our people don't consider. Our people don't understand. People don't think that they're taking their organs. You know what I'm saying? And then the people that do know, they get carnal, man. "Oh, yeah, you got to get guns." No, man. Carnal mind is enmity with the Most High. You got to be more spiritual. It's spiritual warfare, man. It's spiritual warfare. This is where we end, man. How you going to actually fight this? You don't know who's doing it. How you going to even try, man? And you can't swing at a spirit. You can't swing at it. You got to actually have the whole armor, man.
Yeah, the Most High told you. Tries about these other heathen. They don't give a shit about you, like the brother said. Esau's taking your children. Those children are missing. From 60,000 black women, some of them are runaways. You know what I'm saying? Some of them are runaways, but the majority of them, they kidnap. They're having sex with them. They're selling them off. They're burning them to Baal. We just said it's a big season of sacrifice for the weeks, starting the 22nd, all the way to May Day Illuminati birthday, and 13 days prior to that, to May Day Illuminati birthday, the god of Beltan. For them 13 days, it's a high fire and sun and fire sacrifice, man. Mm-hmm. Why do you think the Vietnam War started around this time? The Iraq War started in March. The Roman god of war, Martius. Big things happened. The Boston Marathon attack was in March. The Fukushima was in March. See, that's not a coincidence, man. Then when you go to the last week, that fire and sun and fire sacrifice, the 13 days going into May Day, Illuminati birthday, that's a heavy, high satanic holiday for these devils, man. You had the Waco, Texas attack, Oklahoma City bombing. Look it up, man. There's a list of terrorist attacks that happen around these times because these devils had their own rituals and had their own services, all right? High holidays on the left-hand side to spiritual the demon Satan. You had men like John Todd that came out and said it. These motherfuckers worship Satan. I was in a villa and I saw Rothschilds having a dealing with spiritual demon Satan. That's why they do what they do. Everything the Bible says to do, they do the opposite. Because they're the devil. They're the Edomites. That's why the whole earth is in turmoil. That's why you have sea lions in the West Coast. Their freaking bones is like mush. The whole weather's all messed up. One day it's 7 degrees, next day it's 30 degrees. Fucking snowstorms in Hawaii. Snowstorms in Saudi Arabia. The whole earth is out of course. The animal, the earth itself, the people's bodies, this damn devil is pushing out that homosexuality energy. And our people are becoming faggots, lesbians, and that's affecting the earth because our bodies come from the earth. Our actual bodies come from the earth. You fucking dumb, stupid, fucking assholes. And then you go around, you eat this garbage-ass goddamn food, right? That's why we push the health of the spirit power. How about Shimmy Shot? Change your fucking diet too, man. All you brothers and sisters out there, man, you better start fucking eating better too. Don't talk about we in hell. This is a fight. We're in a constant fight, all right? We're in a constant fight. And everything we do is a fight. And we have to better ourselves, man. No fucking excuses. Oh, we're in hell. Look, I'm just going to eat the McDonald's and we're in hell. Fuck that shit, man. Have some goddamn fucking discipline, man. Go ahead. Well, this devil, guess what? He's satanic priest. They ain't fucking resting. They're in the fucking mountain right now fasting. You know that? Why you motherfuckers out there shoving McDonald's and human sacrifice blood down your fucking mouth? These devils in the fucking mountain drinking wheatgrass. Praying to their gods. They ain't stopping, man. They hot for this shit. So we got to be hot for Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah. So we're battling these demons, man. And we're praying and we're standing crying. The Lord give us that spiritual powers, man. So we can magnify his name on earth. We're going to get that power real soon, man. The Lord's going to give his men that power to magnify him. And he's going to get magnified. All right? Go ahead. Story 11.
Judges.
Chapter 11.
2 and 11.
11 means destruction too. Go ahead.
And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord. And served BLM.
BLM, you're doing that now. What do you think the abortion clinics are? That's a Baal temple, Baal sanctuary. You know what they're doing to the fetuses and all that? Don't you? There's a YouTube video of a baby. They're taking the tongs like scissors and actually squeeze, killing the baby. And you know that actually baby's making sounds? That you actually can hear the baby crying? Look at the wind acting crazy. Yeah. Fuck you, Satan. Fuck you, man. Go ahead.
And they forsook the Lord's power of their fathers, which brought them out in the land of Egypt.
Yeah, and guess what? The Lord brought us out of Egypt, and you same spirits that was murmuring against Moses are doing it now. Oh, I don't want to leave you. I don't leave America, man. I don't want to leave America. Come on, man. The white man's not the devil, you know? Just come on, man. Get over that slavery stuff. And then when you get kidnapped, and you get put, and you upside down, and they're ripping your fucking kidneys out while you're still alive, Then you're going to realize the white man's the devil. Before America's destroyed, when those nuclear missiles come to hit America, you wouldn't know who your enemy is, Israel. And a lot of y'all still ain't going to know your Israelites. That's why you get blown the hell away. You got to be blown to smithereens. You still ain't going to know the Lord's name. Mm-hmm. So that's why you got to be blown to smithereens. You ain't going to have that mark. Go ahead.
And follow other gods.
Cesare Borgia, Hare Krishna, Buddha, all these other heathen gods. And it tells you that in the Ten Commandments, the Lord is a jealous power. Go ahead.
Of the gods of the people that were round about them.
Go ahead.
And bowed themselves unto them and provoked the Lord to anger.
Yeah, so when you go to church on Sundays, that pagan day Sunday, our people that go to the churches, the Lord gets mad at you. Because Jesus Christ never looked like a pale-faced red man. That's a lie. The real Jews are not pale-faced. The real Jews are the Negroes that got kidnapped and brought here in slavery that was prophesied in the Bible. That's going to happen. Deuteronomy 28 tells you that. You're going to come here in slavery and ships and be sold as bondmen and bondwomen, but y'all want to forget. But the Lord hasn't forgot. That's why these kidnappings on that is a reminder. Wake your black asses up. And your Latino Native American asses up too, man. You 12 tribes of Israel going to learn the fucking hard way. Go ahead.
And they forsook the Lord and served Baal and Ashtoreth.
Ashtoreth. Ishtar. The fertility goddess. Didn't you just have Easter? That's where you get that Ishtar, it's Easter from, man. Baal. And you would go with little eggs. Oh, it's harmless, it's harmless. The Most High is angry at you, man. And guess what? A lot of the kids that was playing with that little Easter egg hunt, a lot of them, they're getting kidnapped and getting judged. Because you stupid-ass parents, man. For not following the law, statute, commandments, following these heathen gods, these demonic deities, your children not knowing, you fucking idiots. You're sacrificing your children to these deities. Then when you get kidnapped, you can't find them. You wonder why. You fucking assholes. You keep worshiping these pagan gods. And guess what? In return, they want some blood. Give me your child. I want your child. And you wonder, oh, I can't find my child. Mm-hmm. You went to the park. What happened? It was, we went Easter hunting this weekend. And now I can't find my child. Because of your fucking fault, you dumbasses. Go ahead.
And the anger of the Lord was hot against Israel.
Yeah, hot against Israel. So the Lord's like, you want to worship these other gods? You want to worship these other gods? You want to bring your child into these other gods too? Guess what? I'm going to take that hedge of protection off you. You did it to yourself. Now let them other gods have their way with you. Mm-hmm. Let them other heathen gods have their way with you. You think they're going to love your children? They're going to hate your children. They're going to sacrifice your children. It's like the brother said earlier, the sister, she just had a child kidnapped. And what happened? What the heathen said? Yo, let's get out of here. Call the cop. Where was the sympathy? Where was the fucking sympathy? These other nations don't give a fuck about you tribes. Mm-hmm. You see it every day when you work the job. It's a conspiracy. You go to the Edomite suburbs, you see none but greens and trees. You don't see no goddamn liquor store. When you come to the hood, you see a church in one corner to get you spiritually drunk. Then you see a liquor store to get you fucked up in the body, man. Fuck your body up. Go ahead.
And he delivered them into the hands of spoilers that spoiled them.
And they spoiled us, man. They took our nationality from us. They separate us from our power first and foremost, which is Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. We are the true Hebrew Israelites. All right? The descendants of Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. That is us. That is our nationality. They took our land from us. They took who we are. They took our high holy days, and they said it was theirs. You got them damn gutter rats in Israel saying they're the real Jews. They gave us black, Latino, Hispanic, Spanish, Dominican, Dominican, Mexican, Puerto Rican. All these stupid ass fucking names, man. But guess what, our people, you had no problem with that, though. You had no problem with that. But guess what? The Most High is putting that fire to your asses. Now he's showing you, he's letting Esau have his way with you, man. He's actually showing the horns of Esau, man, by way of social media. But that is the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, lifting the skirt on this devil, man, and showing his nakedness and showing his wickedness. And that's it, Illuminati. That is your power, right? It's secrecy. But the Most High is taking that blanket out, man. Mm-hmm. He's seeing your fucking, with the whole world seeing. Not everybody knows about the Rothschilds. Mm-hmm. Even though, oh, and my grandma knows about the Illuminati. Oh, Illuminati, oh, the Illuminati. Illuminati, Jay-Z with the Illuminati. Good.
And he sold them into their enemies round about them.
Come on. He sold them into their enemies. Give me that Deuteronomy 28:68.
I got a quick precept too.
Go ahead. That's beautiful. Man, that's you going to tell me the Bible's not real?
Mm-hmm.
The Bible's not real. Go ahead. Click on the thing. You ain't saying mad. That it happened before.
This is
you about to be cut off, Satan. That's why.
This is Baruch chapter 4, verse 6. Ye were sold to the nations, not for your destruction, but because you moved the Most High to wrath.
Yeah. So we angered the Lord, and the Lord took that, because you got people that say, oh, the Most High put us in slavery. The Most High put us in. No, we messed up. That's the first thing of this truth, analyzing yourselves.
Mm-hmm.
If we was to analyze ourselves as a nation of people and be like, you know what? Fuck this goddamn devil. You want to talk about liberating your people? Freedom fighters? Yahweh Shai was number one freedom fighter. If we was to follow the law, statute, commandments and not follow this white man's pagan holidays, don't you know America would collapse overnight? If our people were to pray to the Most High, to the East, and say, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, please have mercy on us, and sincerely, through our hearts, that shit would shake the whole earth. Yahweh Shai will have to come back and deliver us. But no, the majority of our people, no. They want to stay in this fucking Egypt. They like this bullshit. They fucking want to stay here.
Mm-hmm.
Then you wonder why we so-called say fuck shit and ass. Fuck you, man. You know, we're tired of shit, man, really. You blacks, Hispanic, American that come against us, fuck you, man, all right? You motherfuckers that see this DC shit, Esau, and the Pentagon, they had 5,200 workers. They found 5,200 of them Edomites watching child pornography. Straight up in the Pentagon.
Mm-hmm.
DC is a Satan's. That's Satan's toilet seat.
Mm-hmm.
DC. And you motherfuckers still want to come against us and talk about us, man? Most likely, Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai going to destroy a lot of you tribes. A lot of you blacks that smack the American, you're gonna get a fucking wake up call. This little fantasy Beauty and the Beast bubble they're living in is about to get fucking popped, man. This bubble's about to collapse. The economy's about to collapse, you dumbasses. $20 trillion, man, that's impossible to pay, okay? And what happens when you're in debt and you owe that much money? You start a world war. That's how you clean the slate. And these devils are coming to collect their debt. You motherfuckers, you dumbasses. Esau's coming to collect it. These Rothschilds, they want their goddamn money. And you know what's that money? Your fucking asses. Which that's what you are anyway. You're nothing but a stock. That's what you are, man. That's what they see you as. The birth certificate is the same paper as a banknote, man. That's what they see you as. And they're gonna throw you in the fucking camps, man. You're gonna see. They're gonna be chopping your heads off. You faggot lesbians, you whores, you motherfuckers that have STDs, they've been killing you in the camps. Ain't no more hanging out. Ain't no more Nicki Garbages, Kim Kardashians in the clubs. Them days is always going to be martial law, 7-7. You out after 7, you get shot on sight, man. That's what's going to have to take, man. That's how stupid your tribes are. You think everything's a fucking joke. Everything in a goddamn joke, man, okay? Sometimes we might joke here and there, but even in our joking, there's seriousness in it, man. We're doing that to supplant, so maybe some of you dumbasses can wake the hell up. Go ahead.
Got more than that. This is back in Baruch 4-7. For ye provoke him, Selachiah, verse 6. Ye were sold to the nations, not for your destruction, but because you moved the Most High to wrath.
Right.
Ye were delivered unto the enemies. For ye provoke him that made you by sacrificing unto devils, sacrificing and not unto the devil. Most High.
And not the Most High. So here it is. The Most High is telling you to be righteous. The Most High said, well, give me Deuteronomy 28:68.
Got it.
The Most High said, listen, if you listen to me, I'm going to bless you. You're my chosen people. I love you. Listen to me. Like your dad tells his sons and daughter. Listen to me. Listen to me. And he's hard on his kid. But don't go down that route, because them boys over there, they don't like you. Get away from them guys. They're not good for you. But what does Israel want to do? Nah, dad. I want to do what I want to do. And what happens? You get your ass beat the fuck up and get killed and whatever happens to you. That's what happens, man. But at the end of the deal, you devils, because you got these devils. Oh, you guys who's worshiping pagan guys. And oh, yeah, we messed up. Israel messed up. But you devils are still going to pay for touching God's chosen people, because whoever touches you touches the apple of his eye, and God, the Most High, Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai, he still loves us, man. And Yahweh Shai is going to come back to deliver his elect. All of Israel are going to be saved ultimately, but the 2/3, you're going to have to get that spanking from daddy, man.
And you're going to have that shame in the
kingdom. And you're going to have that shame in the kingdom. We're going to be like, yo, man, you was right, man. Mm-hmm. You, man, I'm so sorry. The ones you that came against us, when this devil shows his horns, then you're going to know in Amos 8 chapter, oh, you're going to be running around, oh, shit, yo, what the fuck? And then that's when the fame going to come. And they, oh, the guys was right, but the guys was talking about the white man. He saw the dude, I heard, I know, yo. You're going to be seeing the Lord's name. You're going to be running around, because these people watch us.
Mm-hmm.
Yo, where this Israel thing is in the atmosphere, bro. It's in the water, it's in the air. It's traveling. People are getting in the ear, they're listening. You know what I mean? You think they're not paying attention. People are watching, man.
You had a brother in the camp. A coworker of his came up to him. It was like, yo, yeah, you men of valor? Like, regular coworkers came up to me, you men of valor? And he was like, yeah. He was like, yo, I seen your video that you did on the Israelite women that are missing in D.C., you know? You're going to have now, the Lord is putting the spirit out there for this thing to blow up, man.
Yeah.
To the point where you're going to have people that you never talked to about it before that you may know, but you never talk to the truth about, it will come up to you and start inquiring, man.
Yeah.
And that's why the Lord said, wait, he that denied me before men, him shall I deny before my heavenly Father, which is in heaven, man. You know, the Lord said he going to give us that fame in a place that we've been put to shame.
We put the shame here. I had a brother in the Port Authority came up to me. Yo, I see you guys on video. You know what I'm saying? It's, oh, that's beautiful. But you Israel. Yeah, you Israel. And he passed me through, man. He had the little card, you know, the pass for the train. He said, go ahead, brother, you got it. I said, hey, may the Lord bless you, brother, Lord willing. He bless you for doing this for me. He just for him passing me through, the Lord seeing his heart, like, right. You know what? Lord bless him for that. Yeah. I'm not saying I'm the Lord willing, I'm the elect, but the fact that he knew what I stand for, the fact that he's actually supported, help a brother out.
That's right.
You know, and all you Israelites out there that's not helping brothers out, and you sideline, you chilling, may Yahweh Shem Yahweh Shai destroy you and make it public too. There's a lot of you cheerleaders out there. You're not even doing nothing. You're sitting back. You just come, brother, and you put a like.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm not a prophet, brother. All right, so help brothers out. Send in types. Make garments for brothers. Re-upload videos. Do something. You're just gonna stand back. Here is the greatest knowledge, wisdom, knowledge, understanding, and you're just gonna sit back and put your feet up. You should be on fire for this thing. You want the kingdom, right? You got to fight. You got to fight, man, for this thing. How you going to say, believing the Lord's going to, the Lord said, man, you got to be, when he comes back, you're doing the works. He don't want no motherfucker laying back and just chilling. Oh, man, I'll wait. We might be another 2 years, man. You know, I'll wait till next year, man. Shit ain't really popping off yet like that. Yeah, it is here and there, but not yet. Most I ain't dealing with that, bro. You got to be on fire for this thing. It's got to be your all. It's got to be your everything, man. Go ahead.
This is Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 68. And Yahweh shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships, by the way thereof, by the way whereof I spake unto thee. Thou shalt see it no more again, and there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
Sold unto your enemies. Sold unto your enemies, not your friends, your enemies. And that's in the Holy Scriptures. That's not in the hieroglyphs. That's not in the Kibbutz. That's not in the ancient book of the dead. That's in the Scriptures, man. That's prophesied in the Bible. You got that Jewish devil. He said we sold ourselves. You see, that's what we got. That's why we listen, man. We're not here to convert you devils, man. First of all, you're not Israelites.
Yeah.
You devils are Edomites. Only thing you got to wait for is slavery. To get the shit beat out of you and you being sold into auctioning blocks. That's what you got to wait for. We're not here to explain anything to you. We're telling you what it is. You're going to slavery. You're going to get fucked up. You're going to get sold into slavery. You're going to get your ass fucking beat. You know, just look at them slavery movies. Look at them pictures of what happened to us. Look at our people in the ghettos and the projects. You're going to get that and worse.
Mm-hmm.
And after 400 years, when we get you in the kingdom, after 400 years, right, we're going to look at you and say, get over it. God loves everybody. Because you're going to have to do another 400 years. So that's what these devils do.
Yeah.
Oh, to get over, that's a long time. So guess what? When we get you in the kingdom and we beat the shit out of you, fuck you up. After 400 years, we're going to look at you and say, get over it. God loves everybody. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to be continuing beating your ass for another 400 years. And after your 1,000-year period is done, we're going to burn your fucking asses. All right? We're going to burn you. Oh, my God. Can you say, did you try to exterminate our people with the AIDS, the crack, the Tuskegee experiment, the drugs, the chemtrails, the foods, the homosexuality? You try to exterminate our people. The Trail of Tears coming in cargo slave ships. Didn't you try to exterminate us as a people? But you couldn't. You know why? Because the Lord loves us. And he hates you, Esau. Okay? Go ahead, man.
I got to, just to get that word enemy in the Hebrew, it's awayab or ayab. It says hating an adversary, enemy, foe. Enemy, personal, or national.
Mm.
So the Lord, man, that's the second verse, that second scripture you brought out, and you also brought out Baruch, where it says about your enemies, man. You know, because you Jake's trying to say, oh, that's just a couple of people. You know, that's not all so-called white people.
Yeah, yeah.
Your enemy is national, man. That goes from the elites all the way down to the lower level, the lowest level of an Edomite, man. They're your enemy. And they've been showing you, it says hating, they've been showing you that they hate you since your ass been brought over here in slave ships.
Yeah,
man.
Yeah.
The fact that you came over here in cargo slave ships shows you that they hate you.
Yeah, that's right, brother.
Plain and simple, man. And the problem is that you don't want to accept it.
Yeah.
You don't want to accept that they're your enemy.
Yeah.
So then when shit like the 14 women gets missing, that shit shocks you. Well, it shouldn't shock you because they're your enemy, man. In the ancient world, we knew who our enemies were. Psalms 83 tells you who our enemy is, man. Okay? But you don't want to accept that, so then therefore you keep falling into the traps of your enemies and you keep getting destroyed.
Yeah.
And then you look at your own nation, of people as your enemy that's telling you the truth.
Yeah.
What did Paul say? Do I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth? Am I becoming your adversary because we're coming out here telling you who your real enemy is?
Right. And we're the frontliners.
Con.
You dumbasses. We're the frontliners.
Mm-hmm.
If we ain't saying the truth, which we are saying the truth, the Spirit probably helped by Shem Yahushai, you're fucked.
Not.
You're fucked. Because you're telling me you're just going to keep on going. The white man's going to keep on kidnapping our people. We're still going to be getting shot down by these cops. No justice, no peace. We're still going to be getting chokehold by these cops on national TV, and they're going to get acquitted. So you're fucked. We know what it is. You've been comfortable in your slavery. You got a Stockholm Syndrome. That's what the fuck it is. You love your slave master. But the slave master's going to show you he fucking hates your guts.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Get Out, the movie Get Out, they're showing you in your face what the fuck they're doing. The Rothschilds, at least, they're getting sick and tired of you tribes, too. You see, they respect us. They respect guys like us through the Spirit, and probably Yahweh Shem Yahushua, the enlightened ones, the awakened. They respect us, and they fear us. But you Uncle Toms, you Theos Tomas, your Uncle Tomahawks, they ain't afraid of you. They say, man, fuck you. They want to kill your asses. They want to roll up on you, man. These Rothschilds and these Edomites, they can't wait to get you, man. Well, you know who they fear? Yehovah Shemuel Shai, the men, his men, the prophets. That's who they fear, because they know he's going to raise us up. He's going to raise us up. He knows that. They know the scriptures. They know the supernatural power the Lord's going to give to his men. And they envy that. They want that. But you're never going to get that. All right, Esau? This is what you got. This bullshit over here. This bullshit America, this bullshit world. What we're going to get is the kingdom of heaven, the Garden of Eden, paradise on earth, Costa Rica times a million, pura vida, and you're going to be in fucking slavery, okay? We're going to be in fucking slavery, man.
Right.
All right? You don't fucking do what you're going to do already, man. All right? Because when you come and touch the man of the Lord, that's going to be like a lion when he snaps. When you fuck with his cubs, the lion fucking snaps. And the lion from the tribe of Judah, Yahweh Shai, the king of kings, he's going to fucking snap when he touches his men. The scriptures say that in John 18. He said, well, if this would be my kingdom, my servants will fight, and his kingdom is coming. Daniel 7 chapter, the saints shall take the kingdom. Psalms 148, 149. We're going to shackle you fucking devils up, man. All right? Go ahead.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies for bondmen and bondwomen, and no man shall buy you.
Meaning save you. It's obviously, we need, it's obviously as a nation of people, we need an exodus out of America. We need an exodus out of America. But you don't want an exodus out of America. You want to talk trash. Oh, that Moses never happened. I want proof, brother. You fucking assholes. We're talking about shit that's really going down. You want to play semantics, you want to play games. Like them Kemet niggas, man. Mm-hmm. They don't give a shit like polite to the white man. How the fuck you going to follow somebody like polite? So about you want to make it his success. You know, you a Mason, man. Right? You know about King Solomon. You know about the Jacob and Boaz tower with the checkerboards, huh? You quote Psalms 133 in your rituals. Come on, man. You a Mason, right? You know that. So about success. You ain't no success, man. King Solomon was living large. So about he living large. You ain't fucking living large, man. King Solomon had gold in his braids. You have that? You got a big fucking forehead. That's what you got. That's why he was getting a fucking hat. He got a big ass head, man.
And he was getting harassed by the Beverly Hills cops anyway.
Yeah, uh-huh. Which that could have been a publicity stunt. Could have been.
Uh-huh.
Just to get some fun. He don't care about the people. You see him? Mm-hmm. He don't give a shit about you, man. He don't care about you. But he want to come against brothers that's actually attacking the enemy through the spirit power you have by Shemuel Shai, bringing out the truth. You'll never hear Polite talk about the Rothschilds. You'll never hear that. You never hear him talk about the Rothschilds, the elites. But yeah, of course, service. Yeah, of course. That's okay. Yeah, it's coming. That power is coming, man. We at that time. That power is coming, man. You devils are going down. And you polite, all you other black consciousness, unconsciousness, little gang members, that's a religion too. All you motherfuckers that don't want to get yourself right, man, you better hurry up, man. You better hurry up. Because the doors of mercy about to close. There's going to be a major false flag terrorist attack. And they're going to lock shit down, man. They're going to lock shit the fuck down. This devil's going to show his horns. He's showing you in your face he don't give a fuck about you. He didn't even put an Amber Alert for the Israelite children that were missing. You stupid, dumb motherfuckers, man. That's how we got to talk to you, man. Mm-hmm. You're that fucking stupid.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're that fucking stupid. Mm-hmm. You're so stupid. A lot of you going to have to get your head chopped off in the camps. A lot of you going to have to starve to death. You know that? Famine is coming. You see what's happening in Venezuela? The pretty-ass girls in Venezuela are going headfirst into trash cans to eat. Trash cans to eat. So all you girls, most of you got a sense of humor. All these girls with these little Instagram headshots, they're gonna be going headfirst into the trash.
Mm-hmm.
You're gonna be going, all you with the big booties, you're gonna be putting your booty up just to get some Oreo cookies. You're gonna be going headfirst into garbage just to eat some food, man. Good.
Got a quick precept. Basically, backing up the point that, man, the most high, these other nations look at you, Kim and Cass, and all these other people that's not coming to their true nationality because they know that you're the children of Israel. They're looking at you like you're dumb, man. You think you got some kind of knowledge, but you're dumb, man. This is Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 5. Behold, I have taught you statutes and commandments, even as Yahweh, my power, commanded me. This is forefather Moses, man, talking to the children of Israel. It says that ye should do so in the land whither ye go to possess it. Keep therefore and do them, for this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations, man. So when we're supposed to keep the law, statute, commandments, so these other nations can understand that we are wise and understanding people, man. But our people so dumb because they don't want to, they despise the word, man. And those people who despise the word, guess what? Death. Death. Yeah.
And the Lord said that, why should I attach to you anymore?
Mm-hmm.
He said, I bought you. Even Pac said that.
Mm-hmm.
Pac said, damn. He's like, man, the Lord put us in this position. He said he put us in this position for us to analyze ourselves and say, mm-hmm. How can we get out of here as a people? This is a punishment. He said that.
Mm-hmm.
And he was talking about the fake churches. He said, man, he said, dude, you got gold ceilings. Why God need gold ceilings to talk to me?
Mm-hmm.
Why do God need gold ceilings to talk to me? He said, talk about hell. Shit, I've been in hell. Jail, that's hell. I've been shot. That's hell. Talk about some hell where you burn forever. Mm-hmm. All this religion and shit is just to stupefy people and keep you in a comatose. You're in a comatose, man. And you love your master. You love your slave master. And he hates your guts. I mean, that Amber, I mean, that thing, it pissed you off because you figured that DC girl missing, these school districts coming out, Edomite teacher with the slave auction and doing all this shit, you would figure Jake be on it.
Yeah.
And then you have Edomites actually starting up rallies for that.
Mm-hmm.
So here it is, Esau's kidnapping your children, and then Esau's setting up the rally, and Jake is not even going to the rally.
Mm-hmm.
Jake is not even going to the rallies, man. Young Pharaoh said that. He was right on that. He was right on that, man. Our people are totally destroyed, man. This is what happened to another nation of people. Them Chinese and other heathen nations, mm-hmm. they will fucking kill shit. They will tear shit. They will kill cops. That shit happened recently with the Chinese. They got upset and they killed a whole bunch of goddamn cops. But Jake, in this country, you've been fucking docile. Esau got you like, he got you like in a comatose. He got you hypnosis like, get out. He got you in that hypnosis state.
It showed you that in India, you know, I just posted a video.
Oh, yeah, the Elamites.
The Elamites, they fucking was beating down Nigerians just off of the rip that they seen him in the mall because they tried to accuse some other Nigerians of giving a 16-year-old East Indian drugs to overdose him, man. But it just goes to show you how they banded together and they started just wilding on any Nigerian that they saw,
Jake,
man.
Jake won't do that.
Jake definitely won't do that, man. You know? Jake, you have these other nations, man, curse and call you a nigger, say whatever you want to them, and they want to tell you, oh, forgive them. Oh, just, you know, don't worry about them. Like how they do with that whole shit with like that dude that killed those 9 people in the roof in the church, man. They have Jake over there. Esau puts Jake out there to say, yo, tell them that you forgive them.
Mm-hmm.
Because they want you in that docile state, man.
Yeah, they don't want you. Yeah.
They don't want you to have that lion-like spirit, man.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because they know that if what the scripture says, if he goes through, both treaded down, and none man could deliver.
Yeah.
No man could deliver if Jake get in that spirit, man.
Mm-hmm.
But they want Jake to be in that, you know, just forgive him. God will handle it. And God will. Yeah, but you're not supposed to be forgiving your enemies, man.
That's right.
Not your enemies of these other
nations.
These other heathen nations, man.
The house of David was in that spirit.
God.
Yeah, David and Joab were trying to exterminate Esau. They were trying to exterminate crackers, man.
That's right.
To the point where he had to run to the Egyptians. He had to run and flee because they was trying to fucking take him out. But the Lord didn't let that happen because they had to, prophecy had to take place in this shit. But guess what? It's that time now.
And that's why that dude Nate Parker, I believe his name, he didn't really get that much funding for that movie Nat Turner. You know, and it wasn't really a big turnout because that movie was showing you that you're supposed to rise up against your enemies, man.
Yeah.
You know?
And he read the scriptures.
And Nat Turner read the scriptures. That's the spirit that you're supposed to be in when you're coming against your enemies.
Mm-hmm.
But here, they demonized that movie. You know, they didn't really publicize that. You had theaters saying that it was sold out when it really wasn't. But here it is. You have that movie, 12 Years a Slave, where he was more so a subservient.
Yeah.
That movie was blown up.
Yeah.
That movie was showing you, oh well, you know, just be a good nigga, be a good nigga boy, and then eventually Edomite will come and save you. Because that's what happened. Edomite came and saved him out of that captivity and 12 years a slave, man. But what? The Lord said what in the scriptures? Is Israel a servant? Is he a homeborn slave? That's how Jake is acting right now, man. But that's why the Lord preserved his elect, the remnant, that have that kingship-like mentality that's not going to fall to this devil's will, and we're going to speak out against it, man. We're going to speak out against you, Rothschilds and you Rockefellers, in your own kingdom.
That's what a real king does at heart.
Exactly.
Stands up for his people, man.
Yep. Like Leonidas. Like Yahawashi, man.
Yahawashi, yeah.
Yahawashi was speaking against the Roman rulership, man. And you had Jake's, the Pharisees and the Sadducees who wanted to stop him.
Yeah.
Just like you had during the time of Moses when Moses was leaving out of Egypt. You had Israelites that wanted to go back to Egypt, man. So it's nothing new underneath the sun. We're dealing with the same spirits now. You have the same spirits that are on the right-hand side that are speaking against their captivity, which are the prophets, the men of the Lord. And you got the same spirits that says what? We have no king but Caesar, man. Mm-hmm. That wants to be servants to this devil. All right? And then guess what? The Lord is going to preserve them for that judgment that the devil is going to get too. Since you want to be like your father, the devil, you're going to get the same judgment as him, man. Straight up. I got a precept.
Yeah, and all you fucking agents too. Yehovah Shem Yahushua is going to destroy you too. All you little agents out there, you trying to stir shit. While Buzz is live streaming, you're going to other live stream causing shit, talking shit. Yehovah Shem Yahushua is going to destroy every last one of you motherfuckers, yeah? I hope you know that. You fucking demons. You don't think this is serious, man? You motherfucking agents out there stirring shit, talking shit, making false accounts. You go on their page, there's no accounts. Your brother's doing live stream, going on other live streams, talking shit, causing mischief. You gotta watch out. Brothers gotta really be mindful of these things, man. Brothers, this thing is serious, man. Mm-hmm. Don't get complacent. This ain't no joke, man. Really understand how serious this thing is. You understand what we're battling, man? It's Jacob versus Esau, man. You fuck these regular Edomites. It's the elites. You know what I'm saying? These motherfuckers know we got the wisdom, knowledge, understanding. We're pushing out this truth. Don't think that they don't got agents amongst brothers trying to set you up, trying to stir some shit, because they want to stop this truth. They want to really stop this truth, but they can't because we're just teaching the Bible. But this Bible's powerful. It's a two-edged sword. So they're going to have to set a false flag, do some shit, set brothers up, have an agent provocateur in the camp. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying you're being on some paranoid shit. God. You know what I mean? But just be mindful of these things. You know what I mean? Be mindful. Don't be stupid, man. You know, not everybody's a brother in this thing. You have people that set up agent provocateurs that are set up by Esau to try to trap you into some shit and try to ruin your fucking life. Go ahead. And it's going to happen. They're going to demonize the shit up. You got brothers that get all messed up over people talking shit about them. If you mess up over there, what's going to happen when they put your face in the Channel 11 news?
Mm-hmm.
I'm a terrorist. And the Rothschilds are the biggest fucking terrorists. What's going to happen then when they put your face in the fucking news, huh? And you can't go to work and shit. You Israelites better start taking this serious. You brothers out there, you better start thinking like that, man. You better start thinking really with this up here, man.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Go ahead.
I'm going to say real fast. I'm going to go back into Deuteronomy. The brother said, man, it's truth, man. They scared of us because we got the true knowledge, wisdom, understanding, man. Through the power of spirit, Yahweh Shem Yahushua, from the elders and apostles on down, man. This is Deuteronomy 4 and 6. Keep therefore and do them, for this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations, which shall hear all these statutes and say, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people. And because we not keep, like, the majority as a whole is not keeping the law, statutes, and commandments, that's why they look at us like, oh, these people are stupid, dumb niggas, man. You know what I'm saying? Spits, niggas, and whatever other derogatory name they give Jake, man. You know what I'm saying? But to people that are actually turning to this knowledge, wisdom, understanding, they behind closed doors like, oh, snap. They waking up. They got the understanding. And that's why, like, the brother brung out, they wasn't funding that the movie, the Nat Turner movie, man. It wasn't going to fund that because then that would wake more people up once they keep pushing that vibration up, man.
They don't
want
to dig in that spirit because they know the prophecies. The scripture said, Judah shall be a terror unto Egypt. Give me Isaiah 45:14 real quick. And the scripture say, Judah shall be a terror unto Egypt. Micah 5:7. Israel shall be a lion amongst the sheep, which is other nations. So they know that spirit. Why do you think they infiltrated Chirac the way he did? California, Newark. With the drugs and the guns and all that.
Mm-hmm.
The CIA, the agencies, man, they had a van full of machine guns, assault rifles, and they left in the worst parts of the hood with the crack and the drugs and had them Jakes kill each other. Can you imagine if those Jakes from Chirac and California, Compton and all that, Newark, Camden, if they will repent and come back to the law, statute, commandments, how powerful that would be?
Mm-hmm.
They taking that warrior spirit and putting it in wickedness
mm-hmm.
on the left-hand side. But if it was to take that, because they know Judah would tear shit the fuck up, all the 12 tribes. And they know that David was from the tribe of Judah, and all the tribes was with David, man.
Mm-hmm.
They was behind David fighting. So-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans were one force, one nation. The Lord said, what? Thou my battle axe and weapons of war. And David was the, yo, man, they know that history. So they're like, you know what, man? Where's the high points? Chicago. Chicago means sweet and onion fields. All right, they're the vampire killers right there. That's us. Let's infiltrate them with the drugs of the community. Los Angeles, the angels that are lost. Let's infiltrate them with the drugs in the community. Everywhere, where it's a high point where they know Jacob fucks shit up, they infiltrate it. They have the Satanists, bless the drugs and all that, and they put it. So how you think a motherfucking Chirac got a fucking a rocket launcher, man? You motherfuckers ain't thinking how the fuck a cat living with his mom On Section 8 got a fucking military, a fucking rocket launcher. How the fuck you got a rocket launcher, man? Because Esau put that in there to destroy the people, man. But guess what, Esau? You created gorillas, and guess what? The gorillas going to attack you. The Lord's going to take that energy that Jake got killing each other, and it's going to come to a time where the Lord's going to take that energy, and the thing that you created is going to come back in your fucking face. And that's going to be in this race war, man. Go ahead.
Line up. I got Isaiah 14. Come. So Isaiah 45, verse 14. Thus saith Yahweh, the labor of Egypt and merchandise of Ethiopia and of the Sabians, men of stature.
That's some Africans, some tall African nations. We was always battling. We was always battling them Hamites because Esau is number one, but well, them Ham is number two. Them Hamitic nations, man. David versus Goliath, Samson fighting the Philistines, King Saul fighting the Philistines, so on and so forth. House of David, Benaniah stabbing up and killing the Egyptians, man. We was always going to war with them African nations, go ahead.
Shall come over unto thee, and they shall be thine.
And they shall be thine. So them Hamite nations, we're going to bust them up too, man. We're going to fuck them up too, them Hamite nations, go ahead.
They shall come after thee in chains.
They shall come after thee in chains. We're going to slave them too, go ahead.
They shall come over, and they shall fall down unto thee.
Fall down unto thee. They're going to bow down too. So you elites, you Edomites, and you elite heathen nations, you're going to bow down. You Hamites, you're going to bow down too, man. Go ahead.
And they shall fall down unto thee, and they shall make supplication unto thee, saying, surely the Most High is in thee, and there is none else. There is no God.
Yeah, there is no God. So the whole, these other nations, they going to know, yo, give me Psalms 2 and 8. They going to know, yo, man, these are God's chosen people. And that's when it's going to hit them. Oh, shit. They went in slavery because they broke God's commandments. They got fucked up as a people because they broke God's commandments. Because you see, when you bust somebody upside their head, you'd be surprised, man. They start analyzing shit. When you bust somebody upside their head, you ever got punched inside? I got punched inside my head. And you actually analyze, you look at it, you analyze, you're like, yo, I'm getting punched upside my head. What the? You start analyzing stuff. And that's what's going to happen. When we bash you in the brains, when we bash you in the nation, then you're going to know why you're getting bashed. When we bash Esau on his head, he's going to know why he's getting bashed. Uh-huh. When we send him to slavery, he's going to know why he's getting bashed. When we whooping his back and tell him he's not white, he said, Edomite. Mm-hmm. We're whipping his back, he's going to know why. Mm-hmm. When we taking you other Edom nation busting your face in, you're going to know why.
Yeah.
Your subconscious is going to tell you why, because Yahweh Shai, the King of Kings, every eye shall see him. And when you other nations in the Eastern Hemisphere, when you see the Lord come back, you're going to know your subconscious. That's when this, that's right here. The subconscious, right? That's when it comes. That's when it's going to come right in front of your face. When you see Yahweh Shai come back, that's when you're going to say, oh, shit. We always knew the black man was going to rise again. And y'all going to try to resist. And we're going to have to bust you down. That's going to be the fun part. When we get beamed up in ships and we come down in celestial angelic morphing bodies, like morphing Power Rangers, when the Most High morphs us and Yahweh Shai leads the way, and we go around enslaving other nations and taking your shit. Mm-hmm. It's gonna be a worldwide stick up, man. Go ahead. So you get mad.
Hey, they said in the scriptures, you said they gonna know why, but it's 2/3 of Israel. They getting bust up their heads right now, and they don't know why. That's how you know the Lord said, I send you to a stiff-necked people. That's how you know Israel is Israel, man, by the curses. Because Esau gonna know why he getting busted and getting bashed.
Yeah.
These East Indians, these Africans, they gonna know why.
Yeah.
But you Israelites, y'all don't know why y'all going through what y'all going through right now. Y'all really don't. You got people out there like, oh man, you know, it's just shit. It's just life, yo. You just gotta make the best of it, you know, man. Just try to do right. You niggas are so stupid, man. The answer is in the book. The most popular book in the world is giving you the answer. Why you are in the condition that you're in. But the Lord said, I send you to a stiff-necked nation. And that's like the dilemma that we go through because it vexes us, but the Lord already told us that he's going to send us to people that's not going to listen to us anyway, but we still got to go out there and tell them anyway because we know that there's a remnant, but 2 out of 3 people are not going to listen. So it's like what do we got to do? Yeah, like what do we got to do to get through to you, man? But that's why the Lord says he's long-suffering. I'm going to pull out the scripture real quick. This is 2 Ezra 16, verse, I'm going to start at 18. It says, the beginning of sorrows and great mournings, the beginning of famine and great death, the beginning of wars and the powers shall stand in fear, the beginning of evils, and what shall I do when these evils shall come? Behold, famine and plague, tribulation and anguish are sent as scourges for amendment. The Lord is sending all these things upon Israel for an amendment. It means for a correction, man. He's scourging you. He's chastising you for you to get corrected. He's having these women get kidnapped so you women that are at ease can rise up and understand what time it is, man.
And you men, too. You
know, and the man, like, God.
We worship women.
God.
So they can't rise up, too. They're waking the hell up. You touching our goddesses?
But you rising up and going down to Egypt for help, man. You asking the so-called white man that's kidnapping you to help you find your women that are kidnapped. What kind of sense does that make, man? You ain't got one power. Like, think about what you're doing, man. You're in the land of your captivity, and you're actually asking your captor to help you out in your captivity. It says what? That they're sent for scourges for amendment. Behold, victuals shall be so good cheap upon the earth that they think themselves to be in a good case. And even then shall evils grow upon the earth, sword, famine, and great confusion. So yeah, now because you might have a good job, you know, because Jake don't really feel the effect of something unless it happens immediately to them, man. Unless it happens to their family member, then that's when they're going to really care.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing happened with Trayvon Martin. You had a little uprising for a couple days, or with Mike Brown. But then guess what? Jake went back to being wicked, went back to being niggas, went back to not caring about paying attention to loving hip-hop and all this other bullshit. Until the next thing happens, the Eric Garner, until the next woman gets kidnapped, man. Mm-hmm. But the Lord's going to start happening. These things start happening on a full-fledged. Everybody's about to start feeling it, man.
Mm-hmm.
Lord's going to visit the whole entire earth, specifically you Israelites, man. He's going to start visiting you in your own homes, man, for you to understand what time it is. Because you're not going to understand it if it just keeps happening one instance here, another instance here, man. You're going to keep forgetting because you're so stiff-necked, because you're so lost in the sauce, man. His people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge, all right? And we praise Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai for giving us the knowledge, all right, for scourging us the little chastisement that we got, and it woke us up, man. But now we're sitting out here to try to wake up the rest of you people, and the majority of you not going to wake up until it's too late, until you in concentration camps being hauled off at 3 o'clock in the morning to a place where you're not knowing where you're going. Because you got them immigrants, so-called Latinos, you got the ICE agents, they rounding you up, man, saying that they're shipping you back to your country, but they're not really shipping them back, man. They're shipping them off to concentration camps, and you ain't going to see them. You ain't gonna see him again, man.
Mm-hmm.
That's the times that we in. Esau is ready to activate his final solution. Final solution is either having you dead or chipped, man, for you Israelites, and really the whole world, but specifically for you Israelites.
And you know what, man? You devils, you're so fucking played out, man. You're doing all this wickedness, and you're just fucking played out, man. Mm-hmm. It's just so corny, like, okay. You know, years ago, you got this devil, you know, he kind of was still kind of hitting with stuff. And now it's like, all right, he's going to do a false flag on 322. That's the reason why we're here. Mm-hmm. Yeah, this devil did a false flag in London. Oh, he's damn, do a video. Do a spirit. Yeah, he's devil. He just played out. It's just fucking played out. Everybody knows of your fucking shit, man.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody knows of you, man. And that's all we think about all day. That's all we talk about all day is you. We're obsessed with enslaving you. We're obsessed with the thought of one day putting chains on you, mm-hmm. man. You know how happy that's why the scriptures say every time you put him in slavery, honor and faith he has for his saints. Because when the Lord is bad, yo. Here it is, everybody always want to put hands on these other nations, mm-hmm. the triads, the Yakuzas, the White Dragon Society. They wanted a piece of Esau. But the Lord don't let. He said, you know what? No, I'm going to have my boys.
You got Esau that wants a piece of Esau.
You want Esau that wants a piece of Esau. He's like, nah, ain't nobody touching him. I'm going to send my son, my little boys to grab him. You know what kind of honor that's going to be? That's why the scriptures say that. Mm-hmm. Honor and faith have his saints.
Mm-hmm.
To one day get these Rothschilds and fucking enslave them. And just to see them. And then they're going to look at us and say, what? They're going to act innocent.
Mm-hmm.
After they do all this wickedness, they open up the camps. They're chopping up people's heads off. Even though the two-thirds going to get what they get, mm-hmm. but they're going to try to exterminate even including us, our whole nation in America. So when we see that, and when the time comes, they try to even grab us, the Lord gonna live up to that standard, and then when it's time to get they fucking out, they gonna look at us and say, like they're innocent. That's the devil. They gonna look at us, what happened? Like what do we do? Why are you doing this? And that's when we're gonna come to worship. We're gonna fuck you up, man. Go ahead.
Scripture back you up.
This you know what I'm saying? Because you get so excited.
Yeah.
Just thinking about it, it's like drool coming out my mouth.
You know, I don't get it.
That's why you can't talk to people in the world.
Yeah.
They get to LeBron James, Drake versus Rick Ross, or Rick Ross. This gets us excited. That's all. It makes us happy that one day the Lord, if we only endure, He's gonna give us that, man. Yeah. Go ahead.
And that's why these devils is pushing out that Planet of the Apes movie, man.
Yeah.
Out of nowhere, you know, they came out with them, and now they coming out with back to back to back because Esau, the left hand, the elites know exactly the same thing as the right hand elites know, man.
Yeah.
We know what is coming down to, man.
Yeah.
That's why they're building their bunkers. They're building their space stations. You know, that's why they're pushing out even more harder wickedness because they feel as though, like, yo, if we can just deceive just somebody elect, then we can just keep our kingdom because they know that there's a set amount of number. So they're just, in their mind, thinking if we can just get one of the elect to fall, then we'll stay in power.
Mm-hmm.
But the Lord said, what? If it was possible, you might even see the elect. But it's not possible.
Not possible.
You devils, your pride of your heart has deceived you.
Mm-hmm.
It ain't possible, man. So your plan B is like, all right, fuck it. So we got to leave then. We got to go to fucking space. Or we got to go to underground.
Yeah,
but the Lord got something for that too. Amos 9:1, Amos 9:2, man. Dig into hell. You can't escape it. You got these false teachers out there. So they're like, all right, well, let's get some false Israelites out there. First, you had the false pastors that was deceiving the people, not even telling us we're Israelites. But now the Lord got the spirit out of who we really are. So he's like, all right, now we got to come out with some false Israelites. Because now Jake noted the Israelites.
Mm-hmm.
So now we got to come out with some false Israelites to make it seem like, okay, you could be an Israelite, but if you don't believe in this, and this, and this, if you don't believe in Yahweh Bashing Yahweh Shai, then you can't be delivered because pursuing Acts 4:12. So now you got Israelites that saying that you're Israelites, but they're perverting the doctrine. So Esau is just trying to find ways, as scripture says, man, they think upon evil upon their beds, man. The majority of the evil they're thinking about is ways to continue to blind you Israelites.
Mm-hmm.
That's the main thing that they're thinking about. Is how can we continue to keep these people sleeping?
That's why they only get all this fucking goddamn finance.
Yeah.
All this bullshit. This is getting out of control. The rap is whack. I'm like, yo, they're doing all this shit to keep you blinded. Like these TV shows, the rap music. And that's how you know we at the end, too. The music is, bro. This music is garbage, man.
Mm-hmm.
You can't listen to this shit. It got spirit. We saw about the brother across the street, the Benjamite. He was talking about, yeah, this music got evil spirits on it, man. And it's heavy because as time is going by, Like that spirit, like a lot of, like, for example, I be walking to Newark or whatever, or wherever I be at, sometimes I go to the hood, and Jake is now like, Jake with beards is looking at other Jake with beards now. Like, yo, what's up, brother?
Mm-hmm.
Yo, what's up, I? What's going on? Like, I'm noticing that now. All this shit going on is that, it's in the air now. Jake is on some, is changing. Now Jake is like, yo, what's up, brother? What up? What's going on? Like, I was walking, I almost bumped into a brother. He was like a hood brother. He was like, oh, my bad. I said, oh, my bad. It's all right, brother. Don't worry about it. Like, that spirit, like, Jake is trying to be like, yo, man, fuck this. Like, in the spirit, we got to come. Fuck all this. This white man's, we at war with this devil.
Mm-hmm.
We got to come together. We brothers, man. Fuck all this shit. Come on, man.
You got a precept, man, because guess what? They're going to get the ass beat so bad that they're going to be worshiping us, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? This Revelation chapter 3, verse 9. Behold, I will make them of the synagogue of Satan, which say they are Jews and are not, but do lie. Behold, I will make them to come and worship before thy feet, and to know.
July, go finish it. You finish it.
And to know that I have loved thee.
And that's twofold too, man, because that goes for these Jewish rats. Man, that also goes for Jake too, man.
Because
the Lord is going to show you. It says if you can get 2nd Ezra 16 chapter. He said, then shall my chosen be known.
Yeah.
You got a whole bunch of Israelites out there saying, oh, they're the truth, or they got the truth, or they're the truth, you know. But the Lord going to reveal who his true men are, man. And through the spirit of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, the men with the truth are the men from the elders of Great Millstone, and sincere men that teach that same doctrine, man. Because you even got men that claim that they're in Great Millstone that are not even really about the truth, too. But the Lord going to reveal it in that day, man. And he said that he's going to make those fake men that was claiming that they was the real Israelites, he's going to make them to honor those real men, those 144,000. He's going to make them to honor them, man, and say that what? That, hey, the Lord, that you are the Lord's chosen, man. When that time comes, when that spiritual power comes, Even you know, during the time of Moses, where you had those three men that was trying to say, oh, is the Lord only dealing with you? Is the Lord only sent you? Guess what? The Lord showed those three men who the Lord was dealing with. It was with Moses, and by way of killing those other Israelites, man. And then guess what? All them other Israelites around there was like, yo, the Lord dealing with Moses, man. We got to listen to him. And they all respected Moses off of the strength of what the Lord did, man. And that's what it's all about. The Lord is going to magnify us, man. It's not us magnifying ourselves. We're waiting for Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai to give us that power, man. And he said it right there.
Up. That's going to happen again.
The house of David.
The house of David. That's going to happen again. When David get raised up, a lot of that was that. Motherfuckers are going to respect, man. Motherfuckers are going to respect. You're going to get in fucking line, man, when that time comes. When Lord gives his men that power, he's setting his government up now. You know? He's setting the government up now. You have the elders. You have the house of David. The elders. You have the young mighty men. The warriors. The Lord's setting that up now. And when Lord gives them men that power, and everybody talks some shit, we're going to fly upon them, man. Hey, the scriptures say that, flying upon the Philistines. Well, the two-thirds too, man. Because you see, when somebody gets their head chopped off, when somebody gets fucked up, that's when humility comes into play. You get fucking beat the shit out of you, that's when you get humble. Even Conor McGregor, talking all that shit, when he got choked out by Nate Diaz in the first fight, he was all humble. He was choked out. And he said he's so bad he could beat Jesus Christ. He said that. That's why the Lord got his ass choked out the first time. And two-thirds, you're going to get choked the fuck out. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, man.
This is 2 Nedra chapter 16, verse 70. For there shall be in every place and in the next cities a great insurrection upon those that fear the Lord.
Because that's what they really want to come for, man. Mm-hmm. They want to come for the men that fear the Lord. Two-thirds, yo, the least ain't caring about y'all, man.
Yeah.
Least don't care about y'all. Y'all already devoured. Yep. Satan already sifted y'all. Y'all already on the ground. The Lord, these elites... All right, the Lord of the Flies, they want to come after the ones who fear the Lord, because they know that our power, if we fear the Lord, then that means the Lord is going to do what? He's going to fight for us, man. He's going to fight for us. That's right. So that's where they're going to bring that. They're going to get carnal, because that's what Esau can do. Mm-hmm. And that's when the Lord is going to set up that standard. Go ahead.
Verse 71. They shall be like madmen, sparing none, but still spoiling and destroying those that fear the Lord.
There you go. That's what some of us are going to be martyrs, man. Esau's going to be like
dead anyway.
God, yeah.
We're fucking dead anyway. I mean, you don't want to die. Mm-hmm. Like, naturally, you want to fight. But it's like you get so tired of shit,
and that's
man.
The best way to die. If you got to die,
man, fuck it. Being all old. Mm-hmm. Even when I was in the world, I was getting all old and stuff like that, man. God. Fuck being all old, being a pussy beggar to your woman, just being a simple-minded motherfucker. Man, fuck that. You die in this truth? That's the way to die.
Mm-hmm. That's the best.
That's way a beautiful way to go. Right. You had greats like Bivens, Masha, Yaquab, Bun Lawyer. And you know, that's an honorable way to die for the Lord, man.
Mm-hmm.
Like, even scoffers be like, damn, nah, man, they died. Like, they died coming. Even people that come against the truth. Like, they even say, like, even the naysayers is like, yo, man, nah, man, that he died for what he believed.
You said the dead in the house, that should rise first.
Yeah. Right.
I'm going to bring a quick precept because you got some people that hear scriptures like this and get scared. They hear scriptures like strive for the truth unto death and get scared, man. You know what I'm saying? And the Lord shall fight for thee. I got this is Isaiah 35:3. Strengthen ye the weak hands and confirm the feeble knees. Say to them that are of a fearful heart, be strong, fear not. Yeah. Behold, your power will come with vengeance.
Yeah.
Even the Most High with a recompense. He will come and save you, man.
That's right. So we don't have to be afraid. Give me Proverbs 28:1, brother. Give me Proverbs 28:1. We don't got to fear shit, man, okay? You goddamn fucking devils. You already got TKO, man. Talk about spiritual demon Satan, man. Yahweh Shai already defeated you, man, okay? You already defeated, man. The kingdom of heaven, it don't matter if you kill all of us here. Even if we just disappear.
Yeah.
The Most High is going to raise up a whole bunch. It's not about us, man. The Most High can raise up stones.
Yeah.
We ain't special, man. You know? The Most I could take all of us out and just raise up a whole bunch of our brothers stronger,
mm-hmm.
more powerful through the inspiration of us dying for the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
That could you killing us is going to make it worse.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, I showed you with Mel Gibson with Braveheart when they killed Mel Gibson at the end.
Mm-hmm.
What happened when they killed him? They chopped his body parts and they took one head here. They put it here. They sent his arm legs to humiliate him. What happened? The army came back even fucking stronger, man. The Scots got even stronger. God. So if you kill us, it's for your fucked.
And even where in Dragon Ball Z, then Goku died his son, and then Gohan got mad stronger and wound up killing Cell or something. You know what I'm saying? He had that come out. He got stronger seeing his father, you know, fall down. You know what I'm saying? Seeing his brothers get killed and stuff.
The 300 and Leonidas.
Leonidas, yeah. Oh, yeah. They got bigger.
Yeah.
Oh, damn. When the internet went down? When the internet went down one time? When they took down a website?
Yeah.
So you take us down, we just vanquish, we just disappear. That's gonna make it worse because people want to ask questions. Like, yo. Hey,
when they say baby kids, we don't die, we multiply.
That's right, yeah. That's right.
So you know it's a fuck. So you're fucked, man.
Go ahead. Finish that in Second Ezra's.
Verse 72. For they shall waste and take away their goods and cast them out of their houses.
Hey, and that's why Paul said, yo, count your life as a dung, man.
Yeah.
That's why he said that, yo, that don't care about the stuff of this world, man, because if they cast us out of our house, they ain't doing us a favor. Yeah. You know what I mean?
We're gonna pay no more rent. I'm tired of being broke. So don't be in jail, motherfucker.
Yeah, Esau,
that's the worst thing you can do.
And that's the thing about Esau, man. He only can deal on a carnal level. So he's gonna try to think, yo, maybe if I throw him out of this house, maybe if I lock him up. Not knowing that we already had dreams of us being locked up and then preaching in a jail cell and then having a whole bunch of electors wake up in a jail cell, man. Yep. So even if you throw us in a jail cell, if you throw us in prison, we already know what time it is, man. The Lord going to give us that spirit because you got men that are that are part of the elect that's in jail that need to hear this word, man.
That's right.
So you can't do nothing against the truth, only for the truth, man.
Kind.
So it ain't don't matter what you devils do. The Lord's plan is going to prevail. Plain and simple. Yeah. You can't win.
And that's why the scriptures say eat the whole roll, man. You got to eat this whole roll because even the scriptures say when you are brought down to a low state, take it cheerfully, man. You know what I'm saying? So you can wind up homeless. You can wind up, you know, losing a girl, losing your house or whatever the case may be, getting afflicted in your health or whatever the case may be, man. You take it cheerfully like, man, fuck it, man. I'm going to go harder for this truth, man. Straight like that.
That's right.
This is verse 73. Then shall they be known who are my chosen.
Then shall be known who are my chosen. When all this hell breaks loose, when Jacob's trouble happens, that's when the Lord's going to set up that standard, man. Isaiah the 59th chapter. The ones who stay steadfast in the faith, the ones who kept enduring this light affliction, because it's light. Yeah, we go through hell in the flesh, but when you think about the grand scheme of it, it's just light, man.
Mm-hmm.
It's light.
Most I could really put some hell on your head.
Really?
God. Stop crying about your hell, man. God really put some fire to your ass. Keep fucking around.
God. It said, "There shall be known who is my chosen." Go ahead.
And they shall be tried as the gold in the fire.
That's right. And that's what we're going through right now, being purified, going through this affliction, all right, being tried as a fire so that what? We can come out as pure gold, man, so that we can run to and fro like sparks, so that we can be, you know, seem even worthy when we're really not. But the Lord can have us get that spiritual power, man. And then we're going to shine. Scripture says that, man. We're going to literally, the Lord is going to set up men that's going to shine on this earth, man. You think
literally,
celebrities?
Literally.
You think Odell Beckham is something?
Yeah, man.
Jay-Z
yeah,
is something?
Yeah, man.
It's going to be incomparable what the Lord has in store for his elect, man. Regular nobodies, man. Scripture says that we're babes, meaning unlearned and unskilled. We're the offscouring of the world, but he's going to make us shine as pure gold, man. Golden wedges of Ophir, man.
That's why they always have DBZ always golden up.
God.
You got to really think about that. You watch these animes. That's the spirit probably how about Shimmy Awashai.
Mm-hmm.
Us growing up, DBZ, X-Men. This, what the Lord, when the Lord gives his men that power to actually heal the elect, feed the elect, when the fam is coming, you know, to feed the multitude with the fishes and the loaves. That's beautiful, man.
Huh.
Get the power to kill the damn martial art who they come to hurt the sheep. Give us the power to fucking back them doubles up and to heal the multitude of sicknesses of the we're at that time. Acts 2nd chapter, man. The speaking different tongues, mm-hmm. The healing, you always bring that out. Casting out demons, legion of demons, withered hands, AIDS. Go up in a hospital to the spirit power of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai and heal everybody of AIDS.
God, raising the dead.
Raising the dead. Come on, man.
You gotta believe in that too, man.
Right. Yeah, you gotta believe in that.
This ain't just reading it. You didn't say just reading in Acts, man.
The
prophets was doing this.
You gotta believe
Lord,
it, man.
The Lord is about to have this happen again on the earth, man. And he's gonna give it to the ones who really, truly believe in it. and not just sitting around, you know, oh, well, you know, maybe when that, happens, I'll see some great light come upon me, and I'm going to lift and levitate, and I'm going to do a 360, and I'm going to have the power.
You got to make the fucking, you got to make it happen.
The scripture says what? The kingdom of heaven is within you.
It's within you.
The scripture says that ye are God's.
Yeah.
So it's already in us, man.
Yeah, I've been thinking that, man. People talking, I've been like, man, most, right now, lightning to come down.
God. That's why the Lord said what? Where will there be faith on earth?
Because
all this happens through faith, man.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And that's what it's all about. Exercising and increasing your faith. Believing that the Lord already had that, is going to, already has that power in you, man. Mm-hmm. You just gotta push it. You just gotta actually have the faith that it's gonna happen, man. And that's what it's all about in these times, because in this time, in this day and age, there's no faith on the earth, man. Mm-hmm. There's no faith on this earth. Nobody cares. Nobody really believes in anything, man. Only the elect really believes in something. Only the elect truly believes in this word. And we got to, as the hopeful elect, we got to exercise that, man. We got to exercise having that spiritual power.
Mm-hmm.
Not just waiting, oh, well, I'm going to wait till he gets the power. And if he gets it, then that means hey, man, the Lord is going to give the power to the what? So it said, then shall my chosen be known.
That's right.
If you believe that you're a Lord willing, a part of that elect, that chosen, you're going to show it. He's going to give you the power.
Now, quick precept, Ephesians 6:16. It says, above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith we shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked, man. You know what I'm saying? Having that faith. You know what I'm saying? When people think of a shield, you probably think of a shield like this, you know? You got a little faith. You don't want no little shield. How much more actual spiritual shield, man, covering your whole body? Being able to take bullets like Luke Cage, not being able to get your body penetrated. That's the time you got it. The mindset you got to actually have, man, when those times come.
God.
It's back in 2 Nedrus 16 and 73. Then shall they know who are my chosen, and they shall be tried as the gold in the fire. Hear, O my beloved, saith Yahweh, behold, the days of trouble are at hand, but I will deliver you from the same. But be ye not afraid, neither doubt, for the Most High is your God.
There you go. It says, be ye not afraid, neither doubt, man. Why? Because when that time comes, the Lord ain't gonna be dealing with no doubters, man. He's not gonna save you if you doubt him, man. The scripture says what? Without faith, it's impossible to please the Lord.
That's right.
So if you doubt in the Lord's power, how you gonna doubt the Almighty? How you gonna doubt somebody? How you gonna doubt the entity that is all powerful? What kind of how does that make you look in the eyes of the Lord, man? That's why he said, "Don't be not afraid, neither doubt, man.
Mm-hmm.
Don't doubt." And that's what Israel was doing when they came out of Egypt. They were doubting. They were even though they seen the Lord's power. They seen how the Lord jacked up Egypt with those 10 plagues, and they still doubted, man.
Sure, it's going to get so bad, we're going to need spiritual powers. Because the times that we're living in, this devil, that there is a righteous power on the right-hand side. There is a supernatural spiritual power. Because on the left-hand side, these devils are doing it.
God.
They're doing it. They're doing their rituals. They ain't playing. They ain't taking no rest. They got their satanic priests in the mountains praying to Satan, sacrificing those girls that's missing. Doing what the hell knows Deuteronomy 18, Archibald, which came up in Italy too. And guess what? Satan gives him gifts. Satan gives you gifts too.
Mm-hmm.
He gives him gifts, and he requires blood sacrifice. He requires rituals. Like, come on, what you going to give me? I'm going to give you this. What you going to give me? I want this and that. That's where the whole New World Order, that's where that whole Agenda 21, Rex 84, Georgia Guidestone comes in. And then they're tapping into that. So the Lord's going to have to give us spiritual powers, man.
Hey, Esau has... But like I said, Esau has powers on the left-hand side, man. For you to be able to pick up your phone, for you to be able to see us right now, wherever you are in the four corners of the earth, and hear us, that's a power, man.
Mm-hmm.
That's why the scripture talks about the beast had what? Lying wonders, man. Mm-hmm. Power and lying wonders.
Mm-hmm.
Esau has power on the left-hand side.
Mm-hmm.
To be able to have something that's fucking 100 tons fly in the air all across the fucking world, that's a power on the left-hand side, man. How much more the Lord's gonna? He say what? He's gonna make us a weapon to have those lasers, to have those microwave guns. That's a he's actually changing the frequency of the air to burn you without even you actually touching them, man.
Mm-hmm. You actually talking to somebody on the cell phone and they're on the other side of Earth?
Mm-hmm. God.
These motherfuckers do that with the crystal balls.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
The Urim and the Thurim. They're doing that too. They're speaking through the ball. Right now, you can talk
to that's the right-hand side.
That's the right-hand side.
The Urim and the Thurim. Esau took that. This is the Urim and the Thurim, man.
Yeah.
Even the elders said that. Elders said that about Google.
They brought that
up. That's the Urim and the Thurim, man, on the left-hand side. You could Google literally anything besides anything that's non-spiritual because Esau don't have no spiritual powers. But you can Google anything and it'll answer it, man. Google will answer that.
And they want that too, that telekinesis, the telepathic powers. They want that to be able to read minds, to get into your mind. Like the movie Get Out, Hypnosis, to control your mind. They actually want to be the Most High.
God.
That's when that whole chipping comes into play.
Mm-hmm.
They want to have, like the movie Cerebro with X-Men, they actually want to be that. They want to know what's in your mind. They want to control what's in your mind. And if they could control your spirit, they would love that.
Yep.
Because that's total dominance. That's why the scriptures say, don't be afraid of them that can hurt the body.
Right.
Or be afraid of them that can hurt the body and soul, which is in hell.
Right.
Because this devil knows if he kills you, you're in peace.
Mm-hmm.
So he needs you here on earth to be a slave, to do his bidding, to do his work. He don't want to kill all of Israel. He just wants to kill a lot of you, to make examples out of you, and to scare the hell out of you into subjection. And then that's where that whole the FEMA camps and the Georgia Guidestone comes into play.
Mm-hmm.
Well, a lot of you tribes see Esau going to this thing, you're going to subject. But the elect are not going to bow down no matter what, even if it takes death.
God, precept too, because you know what I'm saying, the brother's right. And that's a gift too, that the elect is not going to be scared, man. This is 2 Timothy chapter 1. We'll start at verse 6. Wherefore, I put thee in remembrance that thou stir up the gift of the Most High, which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. For the Most High have not given us the spirit of fear, not the scare of any. All brothers going into detail and examples of Esau's power. But guess what? The Most High didn't give us a spirit of fear to fear what Esau got, man. To not fear what Esau can do to us, man, to our flesh. You know what I'm saying? The brothers say, he kill us. Guess what? We in peace, man. We ain't got to pay no bills. We ain't got to deal with this bullshit. This depression, man. Fuck the weather. This defiled foods and all the other bullshit. It says, for the Most High have not given us the spirit of fear, but of power. That's the Most High gives us power when you come to the Lord's Statutes and Commandments, man. With this word, this is power, man. Cutting this whole matrix up, man. Cutting this fake fabrics up, man. Of this word is this veil over people's eyes, man. To wake people up to the truth. It says, end of love. That's right, man. The Most High's love is what? If you love me, keep these Lord's Statutes and Commandments. And that's how you know that you love the Most High. That's how you know the Most High love you. And that's how we know that the children, that we love the children of the Most High power. When we tell them to get right. And what? To keep what? To keep these Lord's Statutes and Commandments? To come back to the Lord? Right? It says, end of a sound mind, man. End of a sound mind. Not to be drunk with these other philosophies. Not to be talking about, you know, getting all carnal, talking about us get guns, pick up guns. Nah, that's not our power, man. This is our power, man. This is the power right here. It says, verse 8, be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me his prisoner, but be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel, the good news, according to the power of the Most High, man. Because we're going to get, you know, the elect going to get that spiritual powers. And if you don't be scared, man, be strong, man. Strengthen up. Gird up thy loins like a man. I command. The Most High demands you to gird up thy loins like a man, man.
That's some fucking balls. You're a slave anyway. Esau's still going to roll up on you. The economy's still going to collapse. All hell's going to break loose. And you're going to cry for God then. You're going to cry for protection then. Best believe. Because all you motherfuckers out there saving food and all that shit like that, let me tell you something, man. That shit ain't going to save you. There's gonna be people gonna be bobbing into each other's homes. You see what happened in Brazil? What they was doing, the gangs and mobs leaving blood trails of blood, man. Trails of blood. Of rape, murder. You women just gonna be out there too. You women that's not with men in the Lord right now, you're just gonna be out there, man. You're gonna be going head first into trash cans to eat food, man. That's how bad it is. Cannibalism's coming back. You understand how serious that is? Cannibalism? How you motherfuckers don't got no damn discipline? You don't fast, all right? You don't change your diet. You don't try to put greens and fruits in your body. You know what I mean? You don't have no faith, first and foremost, in Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh, Shai. You don't believe in nothing. You believe in the system, and Esau going to turn on your fucking asses. That serpent's going to bite you, Eve, man. You got a scripture? Give me that scripture. You've been holding this. Proverbs 28.
Proverbs 28 and 1. The wicked flee when no man pursueth, but the righteous are bold as lions.
So we got to be bold as a lion. Give me Isaiah 59:19. We got to be bold, man, like the brother said. Like the brothers was talking about. Don't be afraid. What is there to be afraid of, man? That's the demons. Those are doubts.
Kind.
Like the brother was saying, you got to believe in this thing. You understand what I'm saying? A lot of brothers don't even push out supernatural spiritual powers. I truly believe that if brothers would really push it and really believe it, yo, man, things would probably pick up quicker, man. But y'all should probably look like, yo, what's up with these guys? They don't really believe.
Well, they really believe? Earth.
Like Peter. Peter was walking on water. And what happened? He started going down. He started doubting. He said, oh, I'm walking on water. Oh, shit. He probably like, oh, I'm walking on water. Oh, shit, am I really walking on water? And then the Lord said, see?
Because you see right there, that shows you how, you know, Jake, we sometimes will react, you know, off of instinct.
Yeah.
And that's what Peter did. You know, Peter didn't even think about it. He was like, oh, that's our Lord. I'm going to hop out. Boom. Yeah. He didn't. At that moment, he forgot that was actually water.
Yeah.
And that, you know, with man, you ain't supposed to be walking on water. But he just he just seen the Lord. He's like, I'm about to go out there and talk and meet him. But then we started walking. He was like, then the flesh came over. He's like, I'm really walking on water. And that's when he fell through. And then that's when the Lord battled. Was like, yo, why'd you doubt? You was on it for a minute. Why'd you doubt? And that's the same thing now, man, with this truth. Yo, like I said, like strongly believe, man, the spiritual power is already in us. The Lord already told us if you already have the Holy Spirit, man, to believe the truth, you have to have the Holy Spirit to even believe it.
Believe it.
All right? And then the Holy Spirit is going to gives you that power, man. He's going to do us with that power, all right? Even to be able to prophesy, that's a spiritual gift in itself.
Yeah.
So if you got the spirit of prophecy, that's a spiritual gift in itself. Why not have any other spiritual gifts? So you're saying the Lord only has this one spiritual gift out there?
Then
that's it? The Lord always showed, through the scriptures, the Lord showed his might through his power, man. Through his men, and he gave them supernatural power that could not be explained.
Yeah, spooky stuff, which means strange and eerie. Oh, that be happening now on a low level. You be saying something, you think about a brother, he calls you on a cell phone.
God, yeah.
Like the other day we was in the car, we saw about the 14 girls missing. We saw about predators. And me and Shai looked to the right, and it was a sign called predator. It said predator. Like things like that be happening. You be saying things, and the Lord, boom, this Saturday through spring, probably how about Shemiel Shai? We talk about the connection to the Lord and that fire. A bus passes by, it says connect to success. There was a fire image. God. So the Lord shows you little inklings, like, oh yeah, I'm with you, man. I'm with you, man. Come on, believe.
That's right.
You got guys that don't believe.
Yep.
That's why our faith is gonna be tested, man. Our faith is gonna be tested. Like I said, spiritual power starts in the mind. It all starts here. They even show you that movie, Lucy. She started progressing. She was being worldly. She was in the club being worldly. And then she got the truth.
Mm-hmm.
And then boom, she started getting serious. And then every 10%, she started reading minds. She started getting that telepathic powers. Then she started getting the kinetic powers. Then she started getting that power to be able to move objects. And at 40, to the point where she just became pure energy. And at the end of the movie, she sent a text message. Oh, she was able to control radio waves, man.
God.
She was controlling the television. She was controlling the radio. And then at the end, when she became 100%, when she disappeared and became pure energy, she looked at the phone and said, I am everything. I am that I am.
Mm-hmm.
So the Most High is everything. And we as sons, the scriptures say, ye are gods. We have that power now. And this devil knows. That's why he's fucking shitting his pants. Right now, he's shitting on his pants. He's watching us right now as we speak.
God.
And he's shitting his pants because he knows what we're saying is true. You heard this, the 2/3 of Israel, our people, they make fun of us.
Mm-hmm.
But the elites, Rothschild, they're watching us. Their red knees are buckling. They're buckling right now. They're shaking. They're shaking right now, boy. They're like, fuck, man. Because they know of our history. They know of King David. They know of the house of David. They know of the house of David, men of valor. They know. When the Lord rose up his army, they know they was fucked.
God.
And when the Lord was with us, ain't nobody can fucking touch us. We came back from war, not even a fucking scratch on us, man.
Nope,
they know
that.
Now one man lost. And that's going to happen, man. You devils going to be shooting your B-12s. You'll be shooting your fucking nukes at us. They showed you in Hancock. Give me that Isaiah 40 and 30. When he shot the missile, the rocket launcher, Hancock went.
He slapped it.
Then the train came. Whoo, he went. And the whole fucking train. That's what happened, man.
Hey, you gotta believe that you'll be able to do
that. You gotta believe that shit, man. The Lord gonna test that. He gonna test you, man. You gotta believe. He gonna test your faith,
like,
bro.
Look at Eli. You know, he was a regular man, but he had that faith. You know, the Lord was with him. He went out there blazing. Bullets just bopping off him.
Yeah.
Not even touching him.
Yeah.
And he was blind.
But he could see.
Yeah, he could see.
Yeah, that was spiritual.
Fleshly blind, but spiritually, he could see.
Because he was. Scripture says you walk by faith, not by sight.
That's right.
That's how we're supposed to be walking in this thing, man. You're supposed to be walking coming, by man. Faith, man.
That power's coming.
Kind.
Go ahead.
Start at 40.
Yeah, 30. 40 and 30, yeah.
Isaiah chapter 40, verse 30. Even the youth shall faint and be weary, and the young men shall utterly fall. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength.
Renew our strength. The Lord's going to renew our strength. Like David, he could bend steel. Samson killed 1,000 Philistines. David was able to leap walls.
Jump over walls.
Jump over walls, kill his tens of thousands. You know what it is to kill tens of thousands? Mike Tyson in his prime could not knock out 10,000 cats at the same time. Mayweather. When David was on, yo, man, the Lord's going to, man, I'm telling you, man, all that supernatural comic book, because we big Marvel fans. Marvel Comics, that's what we thrive by, man. Because I always knew this world is bullshit.
God.
But I used to stick my head into the comic book world because I knew this was bullshit.
Mm-hmm.
I said, that's why them cats be sticking their head into the animes.
Because mm-hmm.
this world is fucking depressing. So they stick their hand to the Marvel Comics, not knowing all those Marvels, they get that from the scriptures, mm-hmm. man. The scriptures talk about when Yahweh Shah was doing his wonders and miracles, they marveled.
And it said Marvel and comics goes back to Comida. Which means food. So
food.
Marvelous food, man.
Marvelous food. This the food here.
Con.
Go ahead.
They shall mount up with wings as eagles.
Oh, and Hancock, what was on his Scully? Oh, eagle.
An eagle. Con.
An eagle. And he flew. And he has so much electric magnetic power. He has such an electric magnetic field around him that when he flew, the whole damn concrete busted around him. Mm-hmm. He went.
Same thing with Hulk.
Hulk, too. Hulk was an angry brother from the hood. That was an angry Judah from the hood, man.
God.
He was angry as hell, but then when he was called, it's like us in the truth, we get mad. But, you know, be angry, said that. And then remember when the big monster was coming, it was Lycus was coming, and he looked, Captain America was like, get mad. He turned around, he looked at real calm, he said, I'm always mad. Just transformed. That's us. We'll be at work, hey, you doing? Hey,
I'm
doing? God. Hey, you doing? When I got to eat, I'm like, hey, buddy, hey, the Yankees, hey, damn. But deep down inside, like, yeah. You know, in our minds, you know, supplanting them.
They shall run and not be weary.
They shall run and not be weary, man. Super speed like Flash, which Flash is an angel. The comic book character Flash Gordon, and they showed you too, lightning. Which that's one of the most highest. He loves to shoot motherfuckers with lightning. The Mount Sinai, lightnings and thunders. And then Flash, he's running so fast, everything around him just, they showed the movie Lucy.
Mm-hmm.
When she was breaking down to the scientists, she told the scientists, man, you ain't shit. And Morgan Freeman was there. And she was breaking down, video of a car going. She was like, when you start everything by one. But no, she was talking about the spirit world. That's where you scientists go off. You start everything by one. But she was going back from the beginning to the spirit world. And then she speed up the car going fast. And you didn't see it no more. She was talking about the angels, man. The angels move so fast you can't see them. So when that power comes, Flash, when he ran, him and Superman had a race. Remember that race?
God.
Superman and Flash, when they had that race.
And that's why the Lord said, that's why the scripture says that a day with the Lord is 1,000 years to men. Because in the spirit world, it's so fast that they're moving so fast that a day to them is 1,000 years to us, man.
Yeah.
They're in a whole different dimension, man. In the spirit world, the spirit world is definitely real, man. Like, there's no doubt about it. They know it's real. Yeah, that's why they got that whole CERN shit, you know?
You can't measure the spirit world.
God.
Devils wish they can do that.
God.
That's what Lucy was telling them. You can't measure the spirit world, basically. This is over you.
That's why they got the Ark of Baal going around the four corners of the earth, because they're trying to summon up spiritual demons to come out.
The demons to come out, yo. The portals.
Portals. That's what that is. That's what that's there for.
Yeah. They show you in the Stargate, the Egyptian Stargate. Go ahead.
And they shall walk and not faint.
Give me a go to 41:15 there.
Somebody in the in the chat, man. Ellen Coos. He said, "The Bible and comic books mythology is more relevant than this type of talk." That's because that's right there. Lets you know you ain't spiritual, man.
Which all of that Greek, comic books, they got that. That was Jake anyway.
But he's trying
that
to say, that's why Yahweh Shah said, if you can't understand earthly things, how can you understand spiritual things, man?
Yeah.
The talk that we're having right now is not on this dimension. This is not on this dimension, man. This is only for, this is on a whole nother plateau, man.
First of all, you devils, the supernatural power, that proves that there's a supernatural power, because how the fuck did you read pieces of monkey shit take put us in slavery? We're naturally strong in you spiritually, physically, and mentally. How the fuck did you take us down, huh? How did you take us down? Because the Most High, the supernatural, our power was against us. It was a supernatural intervene. That's why we went down. But we are our own worst enemy, man. Okay? That's not because you're gonna know that real soon. You fucking devils. You're talking all this shit. But doesn't James Brown dance like a god on earth? Michael Jordan? They say Michael Jordan, they say when you jump up in the air, you go back on the ground, the gravity takes place. 1 second. Michael Jordan was in the air for 0.9 seconds, man. Even Larry Bird said if God was to come down and play basketball, he'll be Michael Jordan. Mm-hmm. Which Michael means what?
Who's like God?
Who is like God? Michael. Jordan. The River Jordan. Those names are spiritual too. Mike Tyson. Michael. Michael Jackson. You know those names? Names are spiritual. Names are omens. That's why you gotta watch out with people named Damien. Ball. And there was one girl named Gollum. Ball. I'll let you want to talk to me. I said, I ain't talking to you. I ain't talking to you. I'm looking at your name. I'm literally looking at your name. I'm studying it. Go ahead. All right,
Isaiah 41 and 15.
Yeah.
Behold, I will make thee a new sharp threshing instrument, having teeth.
Right, instrument like a knife, all right, or an axe, having teeth. With then you stab somebody with it, then they got the little knives. Little spikes coming out, so when you pull it out, guts come out of it. It's not just a regular knife you poke, it's trying to do some serious damage. Go ahead.
Thou shalt thresh the mountains.
I was going to talk about the governments, the mountains, the governments. Go ahead.
And beat them small.
Beat them small. Now the scriptures go into, give me Ezekiel 25 and 12. This is the script, and give me Jeremiah 51 and 19. We're about to close in a little bit. The brothers want to, when you keep on going, man. This is our life, man, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, these days are passing by, and we're getting one day closer to our kingdom. That's why, brothers, right now, we really got to get in the spirit of pushing out these prophecies that we've been through, but going to the supernatural powers, man.
God.
You know what I mean? We got to really start pushing that supernatural power out, because that's how this devil's going to go down. Through the spirit power, Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, giving us that spiritual power, that's how this devil's going to go down. So we got to really start pushing that out, too, man. Because these devils don't like that type. That's why he sends these little age provocateurs to be going back and forth and gossiping with each other and shit.
Yeah.
Because he wants for you to take that energy instead of going at them and coming at each other, buying a little bit more time. But there's a day, an hour, and a second, a minute where you double the people down and you ain't going to pass it, man. Okay?
Right, this is Ezekiel chapter 25 and 12. Thus saith the Lord God power, because that Edom hath dealt against the house of Judah by taking vengeance, and have greatly offended and revenged himself upon them.
Yeah, you went crazy on this, man. No, you after a certain amount of time, you're supposed to tell us who we are. You never did that. You still told us we're Black, Hispanics, and Native Americans. You know? That's why through the spirit power, Yahweh Hashem Yahushua, we found out our identity, man. The elders woke us up, and through the spirit, we're waking up to sheep. Our people are waking up to the four corners of the elect. They're waking up to who they are. They're not Blacks. They're not Spanish. They're not Dominicans. They're not Mexicans. They're not West Indians. They're not Haitians. But they are Hebrew Israelites. That they are royal people. And the Lord's coming back to bring us the kingdom, and he's setting up his government now. Go ahead.
Therefore, thus saith the Lord God power, I will also stretch out mine hand.
So the Most High will stretch out his hand himself. You talk about us. What we're going to do? We ain't doing nothing. You got to worry about the Almighty, the All-Powerful. You got to worry about Thanos coming back. You got to worry about the apocalypse, man. Who going to destroy you, man? He going to stretch out his hand. You know what that is? So well, you got beef. You guys want, we ain't going to do nothing. Our Father, through his Son, he going to stretch out his hand upon you, man. And he's going to touch you, okay? He's going to fucking squish you, man. Go ahead. Don't get mad. Good.
I will also stretch
rise
out.
Rise them spirits up, man.
I will also stretch out mine hand upon Edom, and will cut off man and beast from it.
Right, go ahead.
And I will make it desolate from Teman, and they of the Dan shall fall by the sword.
So you Edomites are going to fall by the sword. Obadiah tells you that. For thy violence against thy brother Jacob, shame shall cover thee. All right? So yeah, we were biological brothers, but you're that evil brother. You're that negative, and we're that positive. Yes, the majority of our people are negative, but guess what? There's going to be casualties. They're going to be sacrificed with your ass, man, in this nuclear holocaust that's coming. And they're going to come back in the kingdom. That's mercy. Our people are like, oh, you guys are killing each other. in the hood. You guys shot Chirac. Look what's happening. You guys are in jail. Well, guess what? Our people kill each other in jail. They don't repent. Our people in Chirac that's killing each other, robbing each other. And guess what? The Most High is going to nuke them. There's going to be a house cleaning. So you double, then it'd be double trying to justify that. Oh, mm-hmm. But look what's happening. Yeah. Mm-hmm. But look what you're doing to your own people. Mm-hmm. You trained us how to be animals. And our people that don't want to come out that animalistic mind state, they're going to be destroyed with your fucking asses. But guess what? They're going to come back in the kingdom in their right mind. They're going to have a righteous spirit in them, and they're going to be in a righteous society. They're going to have righteous parents following the law, statute, commandments. It's going to be in and out their households. And it's going to be a beautiful kingdom for us. And you're going to be picking cotton, boy. You're going to be picking cotton. You're going to be wrestling dinosaurs. You'll be getting your fucking back whipped, okay? War of the Planet of the Apes is coming out in the summertime, too. War of the Planet of the Jakes. Because the 12 tribes are rising up. Go ahead.
And I will lay my vengeance upon Edom by the hands of my people, Israel.
I will lay vengeance upon Edom by the hand of my people, Israel. So we're all the Lord's vessels. And the Lord said, I'm going to raise up the children of Israel to kick Esau's ass. And it's coming, baby. Mm-hmm. And you Edomites know in your spirit what we're saying is true.
That's why they're coming after Jacob before Jacob come after them. You had that Edomite woman in the restaurant saying, get out of my country and I'm gonna kill you when I get the chance.
Yeah.
Cause they're in the right spirit.
Yeah, they're in the right spirit. I mean, let me kill you before you kill me.
Exactly.
These Edomites are getting like that. Like they know they watch these videos. And once you hear these videos, even you heathens, it stays in your subconscious.
You can't forget this.
You can't forget this, man. It's in your mind. Like, you see the economy going down, you see the 20 trillion, you see Trump, you see the protesting, you see the terrorist attacks, you see this, you're like, oh damn, no, let me get more guns, let me get more bullets. But motherfucking Jake been in the military too. Jake trains too. Jake do MMA too. Jake know how to shoot and snipers too. You fucking devils, man.
This truth is like a hollow tip bullet, man. Mm-hmm. When it pierces you, it's gonna leave a hole.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah.
It's gonna leave a major hole, man.
A hollow tip bullet. Shredding everything, all 7 layers of skin in your body, ripping out tissues and everything, organs.
When I can get the spiritual powers, man, you're gonna be trying to be using those bullets and they're not gonna work. You gonna run out your clip, and then guess what? You gonna have these. You gonna get beat bad, man, with spiritual fists.
And you got it. I'm gonna shoot. Motherfucker, you gotta clean. After you shoot, you gotta clean your guns, man. Mm-hmm. Unless you got an AK-47. Well, you devils act like Jake was in the military, and Jake don't train. Uh-huh. And Jake into that shit. But that shit ain't gonna help you anyway. What's our shield? What's our protection? What's our armor? What's our bows and arrows? Is these scriptures. And real soon, we're going to get that spiritual power, and we're going to be able to fuck shooting a Gatling gun, 1,000 bullets a second. We're going to be shooting a fucking million bows and arrows a second, literally, with that spiritual power, like lightning bolt. The devil's going to get fucked up, man, when that time comes, man. We're going to roll right through you. Like, spirit power, Yahabashim Yahusha. He said that. Give me that. The bows and arrow, Judah as a bow, and Ephraim as an arrow. That's a killing instrument. Don't you know the men of valor, that was their weapon? Yeah, we get the spiritual powers are weapons. We're gonna have the low one of that spiritual power. We're gonna be like, then these devils gonna be like, oh, what the fuck? They'll be using a Gatling gun. And right before they shoot their Gatling gun, they're gonna see a fucking million of bows and arrows, lightning bolts, just for the hell of it, yo. You devils gonna know, like, yo, what the fuck?
Mm-hmm. What the fuck are these technology from? Don't forget that celestial brothers too. That's right. They gonna get busy too. Celestial brothers gonna appear out of nowhere and just start fucking you up. Oh yeah, you're not even seeing it happen. Gigantic angels, big angry black men, angelic black men.
They're not playing, they're not carrying like serious face angry black men, and they're gonna do works, man. They're gonna be on a mission to destroy you, goddamn devils. Good.
And they shall do and eat them according to my anger and according to my fury.
To my anger. That's the spirit. The angels. Which are, angel means messages. We're angels. We're angels. And the Lord's going to, he's going to do something with our spirit where he's going to tweak us. And he's going to tweak our pineal gland. It's going to be a wrap. And people see it now. They'll be like, yo, there's something different about your eyes. God. You have like a spirit, like a glow. People tell us that. Mm-hmm. And then we tell them that's the spirit. How about Shemiah was shot? Mm-hmm. And we explain to them. They see it. So it ain't enough for the Lord to just tweak it, like to just twist it, just turn it up. Really turn it up. Just
turn it back on, really.
That's it.
And put it back to the first estate, like the scripture talks about in Job. Jude.
Yep.
Our first estate, man. Scripture says we are gods. Don't forget that, man. Yahweh Shah said it too. Don't your scripture says you are gods? To be a god, he didn't call no other other race of people gods, man. We literally have something in us that no other nation of people have, man. That we literally have the spirit of the Lord in us, man.
That's why this devil fucking kidnaps us. That's why he sacrifices us. That's why he eats our penile glands.
Yep.
He wants to get that essence. He wants to get that power, the energy. Good.
And they shall know my vengeance, saith the Lord.
And you, and you're going to know the vengeance of the Lord. Don't worry about it. You're going to know that because the scriptures tell you that Amos 9:11. We love to quote that scripture. That's one of our favorite scriptures, the men of valor. He's going to raise up the house of David. And when he gives that spiritual powers, we're going to magnify Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. The whole world's going to know. And your Hummer H1s, your Gatling guns, your rocket launchers, your Stinger missiles, your microwave guns, your B-12 bombers, your Apache helicopters, all that faggot shit, your little satellites, your drones, they ain't going to stop the man of the Lord.
Yeah, priest.
Go ahead.
So Zechariah chapter 8, verse 22. Yeah, many people and strong nations shall come to seek Yahweh of hosts in Jerusalem and to pray before Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shad. Thus saith Yahweh of hosts, in those days it shall come to pass that 10 men shall take hold out of every languages of the nations, even shall take hold of the skirt of him that is a Jew, saying, we will go with you, for we have heard that the power is with you. So when that time comes, man, these other nations going to realize that, hey, wait, the living power is with you, man. The power that created the heavens and earth, he's dealing with you. And they're going to be grabbing hold of us, man. Grabbing hold of us who? His chosen. They're going to try to beg and plead these women, all right? It says the men, these men, all right, they're going to try to follow us, trying to just get down with the crew. Like how you have these paparazzis and these, what they call the entourages with these wicked-ass people right now on the left-hand side trying to get down. They will be trying to get down with us, man. Righteousness is going to be elevated on the earth to the point where that's going to be the only thing that people want to be, man. Mm-hmm. And the Lord is going to have his elect men be in the top tier of that. And they're going to try to grab hold of us, like how they be, like how the Beatles, you know, the Beastie Boys and the Beatles, how they be trying to grab them when they in the crowd. That's how they're going to be trying to grab us, man. Because the Lord's going to elevate us that much that he's going to have us on that literal. We're going to be celebrities, which go back to celestials. All right, we're gonna be the literal stars on earth, man.
You know, all you women, you gonna try to get with brothers that day? You come to me, man. I'm gonna break a lot of your wrists, man. Get that spiritual powers. That time comes, man. A lot of you women, you're gonna get rejected. We got women that's cool with us. We love them, and the Most High be with them. They do the right thing till the end. But a lot of you women, you're gonna get it, man. A lot of you girls walk around like your shit don't stink. Dude, I want a good man. Well, there's good men here, but you don't want to get right. You don't want to be a subjection on the righteous man. You know brothers is righteous, right? But you don't want to be. You don't want to come on the brothers. But when all hell breaks loose, all of a sudden you want a baseball slide on the brothers to be safe.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're going to get kicked and kneed right inside your face, okay? When that time comes, you're going to get kicked and kneed. Because when that time, we're going to be picking that day. And that day ain't going to be no washing. Ain't going to be no razors. Ain't going to be no deodorants. Ain't going to be no shampoo and conditioner. Ain't going to be no makeup. Ain't going to be no perfumes. You ain't gonna be hairy. A lot of y'all gonna have beards. That demon that you try to hide with that makeup is gonna show forth your face. It's gonna show forth. All right? Go ahead. Because the men of the Lord are the kings. Isaiah 13 and 12. Give me Isaiah 13 and 12. Men of the Lord are the kings, all right? And you dumb, stupid bitches are gonna learn that. And we're not talking about the sisters. We love you. We don't have to say that. The sisters, we got sisters that's riders, that's down, and you help us, you know, shall protect them. We're talking about your little dirty little holes, man. I don't wanna repent. And you know what you're doing is wicked. But you want to come against men of the Lord? You want to give men of the Lord a hard time? You better watch out, man. A lot of you got daddy issues, but guess what? The supreme power, Yahweh, Big Papa, he's mad at you, at his daughters, man. Because you, the daughters of Zion, a lot of y'all going to get it too. Because y'all Israelites too. And y'all know what y'all doing is wicked. You don't want to cover up. You don't want to shut your goddamn mouth. You don't want to close your fucking legs. You don't want to cook for your man. You want to give your man a hard time. I'm talking about men of the Lord. You're marking yourself for death. You better get yourself fucking right now, man. Because when that time comes, that spiritual power comes, and the Lord gives his men that fame, yo, don't come then. You're going to come from one ship, and then when the ship is sinking, you're going to jump. No, don't work like that. You better be down with us now. That's like the Lord. The Lord's trying to see who's down with him now. Because the Lord was to show his power. They say the Lord was to show his chariots. Everybody be down.
Mm-hmm.
All these comedic dudes, black consciousness, everybody be down. Like, oh, yo, yeah, that's why this is it. Look, we can see it. It's real. It's,
mm-hmm.
The Lord's trying to see, yo, who's real? Who's down for me now? This one, you got to be down for the Lord when shit ain't popping. You got to be down for the Lord now. This is all about being real, man. Israel, who is real for the Lord, all right? This is the time to be down for the Lord is now, man. Not no fucking, not no when all of a sudden they see the chariots and the spiritual power. You know, that's how Jake is. They even have this thing on YouTube. This drive guy would drive a Lamborghini. Even niggas was acting like bitches. Yo, can I hang out with you?
Uh-huh.
That's how it was in the world. You're doing good, everybody wanna hang out with you, but then when you're down and out, who's there for you? Mm-hmm. You're one or two friends that are there for you, that see you in jail, that give you commissary money, that's there for you, homeless. Yo, come stay with me, brother. Go ahead, man. You gotta be real about this thing, man. Go ahead.
This is Isaiah chapter 13 and verse 12.
Yeah.
I will make a man more precious than fine gold.
A man more precious. And 13 means rulership. 12 is the 12 tribes of Israel. And the Lord is setting his government up, man. Which the 144,000, when you read it, are men. So the Lord's raising up men because the men are the fucking kings. Not you women, okay? Not you women walking around like you shit don't stink. You women are going to gain your fucking place too, all right? That's why you're walking around with goddamn psychotic. You don't know what to do with yourselves. That time going to come, man. This social media is going to get fucking destroyed, man. Go ahead.
Even a man than the golden wedge of Ophir.
And that's precious gold. Because the men are precious, okay? The men are precious. We carry the nation in our fucking nutsacks, okay? And our balls, okay? The most I could just take all the Israelite women away, and we can still bring the nation to the heathen women.
That's what he's gonna do with Moses.
Exactly.
His wife was a Ethiopian, I believe.
She was a Hamite.
Oh, that's a spirit.
Mm-hmm. Which I truly believe, I used to say this, but who the hell am I? I'm just a man on earth. I believe that a lot of these women are going to be, we're going to get overseas, man. Because a lot of you Israelite women, you ain't going to get it, man. I'm not the most high, but I be saying that. Like, women overseas, they're feminine, that this is that. I just don't see it, but hey, who am I? It's part of the most high. We have women out there that wherever the Lord wants to be with you, it's going to be with you on that day. Just worry about doing the works first, okay? Don't worry about these women. They're going to come. Worry about doing this first. You come. Go hard on this, man, and everything else is going to come.
You see that women... They just go with the trends anyway, man.
Yeah.
That's what they do. And you already see how this truth is trending. This is the number one trending, you know, thing on YouTube, man. So the brother said they women wanna come, man.
I see it for more.
It ain't nothing for the Lord to give you in. The Lord told David that. He said, I gave you your master's a house and I gave you his wives. And if that wasn't enough, I could have gave you more.
Yeah, he told him that. He said, why did you do that? And David had women.
God.
He said, why did you do that? If you wanted more, I would have gave you more. That cuts that damn all. You can
one
have another wife.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, first of all, if you see your woman every day, you're going to kill her ass, man. Why do you see people in relationships for so many years? Like they want to kill each other.
If you can't have more than one wife, then that means there's only one elect getting saved, man. Because the Lord said that we're his bride, man. He's the bridegroom.
Yeah.
And he has 144,000 women.
right now, there's 12 women to one man.
That'll be selfish. So what about the other women that are trying to get saved?
That's how you know it's going to get so bad out here. Like you said the last week, it's going to be so catastrophic out here that women are going to be like, man, F all that bullshit. They're going to bring in their girlfriends. So, girl, come on, girl. Come on, girl. We're going to clean you up. You're going to be part of his family, girl.
So you're in the purge. The second one, with a daughter and a mother, they came across that dude that was like a man of the Lord because he was basically all calm, cool, collected when all hell was breaking loose. And the mother was like, yo, let's go with him. They ain't even know him from a can of paint. Yeah. But they just seen that, he could protect us, so we got to just ride with this guy. And that's what's going to happen in Simon Jacob's trouble,
and
man.
And we're going to be seeing that now in the camp. My brother's be teaching and women walk by. You see women like God. A lot of women, they'll put their head down. When they walk by the candle, they'll put their head down. They'll walk by the candle, put their head down. Because in their spirit, they know. They'll see us and they're like, yo, it's heavy because here it is. They're ruling with Esau. They're on top. They're on a pedestal, but they'll pass by the camp and they'll put their head down. You see that beautiful woman mm-hmm. walk by dressing all whorish and then she'll walk by, she'll put her head down. And then she'll pass by, she'll put her head up.
Because
they'll know in their spirit. That's the spirit, man. A lot of these women know, like, yo, man, those are real men right there.
God.
But they get scared because, like, wait a second, if I get with this man, I gotta be good myself.
Exactly. I
gotta change all my shit, but I'm having too much fun right now. I'm being free. But guess what? Esau gonna take away all that fucking freedom. Go ahead.
Isaiah chapter 4, verse 1.
Done.
And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by thy name.
Hey, shalom to the brother Manatazai Banyonyan. That brother be doing some powerful videos, man.
Yeah,
shalom. Boy, y'all brothers, we love y'all, man. Seriously, y'all brother, man, your video was powerful. The last one, the brother did on Yahweh Shai's second coming with the chariots. Man, that was powerful, man. We had to re-upload it. You know, we had to steal your video.
That's a spiritual power right there.
Yeah, that's a bad video. That video was powerful. And at the end, when the chariots and the UFOs came, the destruction came, then it showed the kingdom. Yeah. And it showed the Eddie Murphy clip coming to America, man. That video, yo, that video brought me to tears, man. When I saw that, that's how powerful. Them videos is powerful, brother. Keep on pushing them videos, man. Good.
And in that day, seven women shall take hold of one man, saying, we will eat our own bread and wear our own apparel. Only let us be called by thy name.
Yeah, that's right, man. So that time going to come, women going to be somebody independent. That's how they're going to be, man. That's how bad it's going to get out here. Women going to be like, yo, let me just be part. Let me just have your name. Now you got women doing that in the courts, in Esau's courtroom. They taking the wife's name. No, women going to go, you know what, let me just be your wife, please. They're going to be pleading, please, please. Women that always rejected you and never gave you the time of day, they're going to be like, please, please, let me be with you, please. They'll be looking pitiful, man.
And that's how you know that's a future prophecy, because back then during that times, women, it was normal for a woman to, you know, well, first of all, it was normal for a man to have multiple women back then. And then second, it was normal for a woman to be humble back then. So right there, it said, like, that was showing you that something, like I said before, like, that during this time where you see women so high-minded and so lofty and thinking that they shit don't stink and that they can be independent, that it's going to come, that it's going to be such a reproach on their lives that they want to say that we'll do whatever, we'll take care of ourselves, just let us be called by your name. So that lets you know that we're coming into that time, because the women now are so far from how the women were back during those times where Isaiah wrote this. So the scripture talks about, what was that scripture? It says that rise up, you women that are at ease. That's another prophecy, man. The women that are living right now, the way that they're living, man, it's just crazy, man. Like, you just said, everything is so, it's women, is they got this feminist shit. I haven't heard that word so much this past year. That I heard it my whole life, man.
Where the fuck they at? Where's the white feminist with the girls missing? No, we don't know where to be found.
That, you got all them pushing out women on social media talking about, oh, I'll take it, like, I'm so self-sufficient that all I'm about is my money, my career. Like, that's not the way that the women of the world were, man. Mm-hmm. So that's how you know where we're at the end, because our women are so far what they used to be, man. And so are the men too. But right now we're talking about the women. They're so far from what our ancient women used to be, man.
And women back then, they would chase men. Mm-hmm. Like, even now, like, women were actually want, they respected men. They looked up to men. Now these women forget about it. Ever since they got these jobs, they don't have no respect for men. They had no respect whatsoever, man. Back then, women would dig men. They would break their necks. Everything's spiritually flipped now. Men breaking their necks to get attention for women. Back then, women, because it's like, what, 12 women to one man even now, women would break their necks to get with you, man. But now everything is fucked up. Everything's all messed up. And it's easier when a woman is digging you. Everything is much easier. You know, a woman's supposed to be crazy over heels over you, not you crazy over heels over your woman. Yeah, you love your woman, but you're supposed to be emotionally balanced in your mind. She's supposed to be crazy over you, man. That's supposed to be all bugged out. You got dudes on YouTube crying, oh, she left me.
Who's my cinnamon apple?
What the fuck? I remember I was like that when I was in the world, when I was a young kid. Now looking at that shit like, damn, that's some horrifying shit.
God.
To actually go through that pain of adultery and your woman cheating on you and all that, we didn't go through that back then. You didn't really hear too many accounts of adultery in the scriptures, man.
God.
But that wasn't play with. That's a horrible thing to go through. Actually, adultery, some people that are homeless shot themselves. My best friend killed himself. There's one woman that he loved cheating on him. He actually killed himself, man. That shit hurts. That's why this devil, that's why Esau, when we get you, man, we are going to completely fuck you up, because you caused all this cancer on the earth. You Rothschild's leads. You Edomite, you caused all this chaos that's going on. This is not imaginary. This is not just magically just happening out of nowhere. No, there's people that systematically designing this, conspiring, conspiracy against to destroy our nation. And you've done that.
Hey, and that's why Esau, he's pushing out this feminist shit, because how did Esau get Jake to go to fuck up in the first place? Starting with Adam and Eve.
Yeah.
The serpent, all right, which was Esau, used the woman to deceive Eve, man.
Yeah.
So that's why in these times now, Esau's doing the same old fucking tricks. That's why scriptures calls him that old serpent, man. He's using the same thing that he used in the beginning to try to deceive Jake, man, try to deceive Adam, okay, by using a woman. So he's going to have women, yo, you know, be feminist, you know, be a strong, independent black or Latino woman, all right? And make your man be subservient. And make your man be a little effeminate. And tell him to cut off his beard. Tell him, you know, that you can eat whatever you want. And Esau, I mean, the woman being a weaker vessel just eats it up. And she tells her man, and you simple ass Jakes, y'all go and do it. And this is a perpetual cycle of this fucking devil, man. That's why he going, yo, you got so much to pay for, man.
We're going
to,
yo, man, I mean, I don't even know how you're going to make it.
Yo.
All this frustration and fucking anger. Man, I don't, man, we're just going to, maybe the first day we get him, yeah, Howard Shaq, probably, we're going to throw a whole bunch of him off the mountain, bro. Like our ancestors used to do. We're going to take a whole bunch of Edomites and just throw them off the fucking mountain, bro. That's the first thing we're going to do when we get you. We're going to beat the shit out of you. We're going to take you on top of our high mountain. We're going to be drinking wine. We're going to be popping bottles. And we're just going to push you devils off the cliff. And you're going to fall. Ah, pow! Mm-hmm. And we're going to be popping bottles.
You're going to raise your spirit back up.
You raise your spirit back up. And we're going to do it again. Pow! Right?
And brother Zakaria said, Eve got Jake's eating ass now. And that's true,
Yeah.
Can't get with me unless you eat the booty like groceries, all this crazy madness.
God, that's not supposed to be. That's fucking wicked,
that's
man.
That's a
song?
It's way out of
it. It's a song.
Sodom, man.
Sure, that's way out of line.
Hey, the scripture talks about it. You declare your sins at Sodom, man. Mm-hmm. You're declaring your sins. Get that scripture, Isaiah 3. It says you declaring your sins at Sodom. Yo, y'all be hitting, I'll be popping her in the ass. Yo, hey, y'all be eating her ass, she be eating my ass.
Shit on the face.
All this ass talk, man. Y'all niggas is ass backwards, man.
For real.
Bruh, that's why the Lord said what? That it's gonna be more tolerable in the day of Sodom and Gomorrah. Because I was talking to the brother the other day, I'm like, yo, Sodom and Gomorrah was wicked. But I'm pretty darn sure there wasn't no fucking transsexuals in Sodom and Gomorrah, man. That's some new level shit, man. When we was chilling in the at the camp, and then that thing came in, and brothers had to actually contemplate. It looked like a woman with a fat ass, but she was kind of big, and her hands was a little big.
And
we was over there contemplating, yo, is that a man?
I said, that's a fucking man, saw the hands.
And then that's how you know we're in a fucked up society, to the point where you literally see something that looks like a woman, but you gotta double guess yourself to think if it's a woman or not, man.
Oh, now they can get the surgery done, the birth certificate changed.
God, yep. And they even gotta tell you that they was born a fucking man. So you could be fucking a man that got a vagina, you not even know this shit. But then Esau wanna throw you in jail if you find out you kill that nigga, man. This is why we gotta get the fuck up out of here. Yeah, America has to be the fucking destroyed, man.
Yeah, exodus out of here, man.
We literally need the power to come take us out of this place, man. Get that scripture? Start at, go to Isaiah 1 and 9 and jump to 3 and 9.
Con. This is Isaiah chapter 1, verse 9. Except Yahweh of hosts had left us a very small remnant, we should have been as Sodom, and we should have been like unto Gomorrah.
Except the Lord has left us a small remnant. Who is that small remnant, man? The hopeful elect. If it wasn't for the hopeful elect, if the Lord completely took out the elect out of here, the rest of eventually everybody would be fucking faggots, man.
Yeah.
That's where the society's going. Everybody's either effeminate or a faggot or transsexual, bisexual, trisexual. That's where this place is going, man. Scripture says that lest there'd been a remnant, which the Lord for the elect's sake is gonna, you know, destroy this place, but he says what? That they would have been like Sodom and Gomorrah. Go ahead.
Isaiah 3 and 9. The show of their countenance doth witness against them, and they declare their sin as Sodom. They hide it not. Woe unto their soul, for they have rewarded evil unto themselves.
There you go. It says they declare their sins as Sodom. They hide it not. Gay pride? That's a shameful thing, man. Homosexual pride is a shameful thing. But now they declare their sins.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gay and I'm prideful. You got fucking 4 or 5 year olds talking about boys talking about I want to be a girl, giving them the option to go into these different elementary schools, having transgender elementary schools bathrooms, man. You're declaring your sins as Sodom, man. And you don't even hide it anymore.
back in the day, there used to be something called what, the DL, the down low. Mm-hmm. This shit not down low no more, man. It's like it's opposite. You gotta be a DL, a down low straight guy now, man.
Yeah. They try to demonize. But it's deep because as this is happening, a lot of women are looking for men in the Lord now.
That's right.
They're looking for men with beards. They're getting tired of this bullshit. You see a lot of women now, they're looking for men in the Lord. Like, yo, man, like that vibe is coming out. I remember years ago, you wouldn't see Simeonites, Ephraimites with beards. Like, you saw Ephraimites with that Muslim shit, but you never saw Dominicans with beards. You see Mexicans now with beards. You see, that's that Lord putting that spirit. You know what I mean? A lot of men are standing up to these women too. Like, man, fuck yeah, man.
Those people, what's more sick than actually be down with that LGBT community is people that's like, oh, I don't really care for it, or I don't care. Let them do whatever they want, man. Because that's how a lot of that shit start, man. You in your mind thinking like, well, it's not that bad. Only let them do what they want. Because then you went from that curious thought or to letting them do it. Now you're down with it. Now you're a lesbian or a faggot. Then from being a lesbian or a faggot, you got them cutting off your private sign or adding a penis to your fucking vagina, some bullshit. The next thing you know, you're a nigga that used to be a bitch. And, well, no, you're a bitch that used to be a, whatever the case may be, but now you want to have kids, man.
Well,
you
got a penis and shit. A man that used to be a woman. And now they used to be a woman having a child used to be a man. Man. Yeah,
it's straight confusion, man.
That's fucking Babylon. Baphomet, man. That's the spirit of Baphomet. That's what these devils is conjuring up in these times, man. All these wicked ancient deities is here in Babylon. That's why the scriptures call this place what? The daughter, the Babylon, the great, man. Confusion, the great confusion. This shit is just all fucked up, man. But what? The Lord got the remedy for that.
Kind.
Which is what? ICBM missiles, man.
That's a beautiful way to end this shit. That's a beautiful, this disgusting, evil, satanic empire. That's a beautiful way to end this shit. Because you know what? You can't raise a righteous family here.
Got it.
You can't. You can't. You cannot, man. You want to have a family. You want to live in peace. That's why, and this devil has to go down, because if you was, you got to go, oh, leave the country. First of all, if you was to leave this, if we were to have a mass exodus out of America, let's say, right? Like a Marcus Garvey type shit, these devils would come harass us wherever the fuck we at.
They're already there.
Yeah, they're going to be here, exactly. Yeah. They're going to do the same shit again. They're going to kidnap us and fucking get out and put us right here. Hypnosis back in America. They need us, man. That's why this devil got to be brought down.
God.
Close out with that?
Yeah, you close it up.
Yeah, come on. That's it no more?
God, yeah.
Anybody else trying to say?
That's good, brother.
Yeah, but we at the end of this thing, man. You know, the spring party, how about Shemel Shai? You know, we do this video to feed the sheep out there.
I'm going to end it with this. I always like ending with this scripture.
Yeah. So that's your favorite script?
Nah, that's my new favorite script. This is what it's all about. Mark chapter 1, verse 5. And saying, the time is fulfilled, the kingdom of the Most High is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel.
Yeah, repent, man. You know, call all you help by Shimei Abushai, man. Repent, get yourselves right. You know, because, yo, the time is at hand. We ain't going to be always, you know, the doors of grace and mercy is about to close, man. We ain't going to always be doing it. This is not entertainment, man.
God.
You know what I mean? This is the Most High. Through the spirit sign and crying, the Most High is getting tired, he's getting pissed. And we one with our power. We're tired, so we can imagine how he feels. So he gets to the point where we're getting to the point, right, brothers? You're getting tired of talking to people. We can feel like that our mouth's about to shut closed. We're getting real, real numb because we're coming at that time when that hell's about, the floodgates of hell's gonna be unleashed. And you tribes that didn't repent, you don't have that shield of protection, you're gonna get caught out there, man. And then you're gonna remember the men that was trying to warn your dumbasses. That was looking out for your asses, man. To spread power, y'all about Shemel Shai. But you've been warned. Repent and get yourselves right, man. It's the gospel. The kingdom of heaven is at hand. And our kingdom is soon to come, which is going to be a kingdom on earth. When the King of Kings, Yahweh Shai, comes back and restores his people. And as we once was, man. A glorious people, man.
God. Last one. Ezekiel 33 and 33. And when this cometh to pass, lo, it will come. Then shall they know that a prophet hath been among you.
Beautiful. Then you will know that a prophet was among you. Then you will know those guys that was doing these videos, that was pouring their heart out to this prayer party, Yahabashim Yahushai, that was out in them corners, yelling and screaming at you, Isaiah 58, show my people their transgression and Jacob their sins. That was warning you of what's to come, the famine, the pestilence, Jeremiah 28 and 8, of the war that's coming, and you still didn't take heed, so you deserve and what you get. You know?
God.
We are almost out of here. Shalom.
So long.
Call all you have,
Bashing
out.
So long.